Hello and welcome to episode 7 of Keep Tappin X. It is February 17th, 2017.
I like how you had to look.
I had to look. Yeah. Well, I wanted to confirm.
Okay. All right. Yeah,
I have to make sure the date's right.
You never know. We could be in like a paradox, like a time paradox.
We could be in Smarch.
Yeah, don't say that, because now we are in a time paradox.
Yep. Okay. The 13th month of the 13th year.
Damn, Smarch winner.
That's a callback.
Got some interesting stuff to talk about today.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Or to not talk about today.
You know, especially if you're fans of Kingdom Hearts, Resident Evil.
Fire Emblem.
Oh, Resident Evil 7, that new DLC is weird.
Yeah, you recently played the Ethan Must Die set.
Oh yeah, I did that. That was an experience.
Yeah. I've been watching some of them. They look really fun.
Yeah, we'll get to that.
Yeah, but thank you guys for joining us on another week of this podcast. Things have been going pretty smoothly for us. Yeah. Let's Play's doing fine, just fine. And we streamed for the first time.
Yeah, that was
fun. What'd you stream?
For Honor. We streamed For Honor, not the open beta, actual game.
Oh, so you actually bought it?
Yeah, our friends and I got the game.
That game's fun, but man, is it frustrating.
I haven't been salty in a game since I played League of Legends, which was also one of the biggest mistakes of my life. But I don't know, something about that game. It's very brief moments of, pinches of salt.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
You, something happens, and you die because of it, and man, it's the world is against you.
You want to know why I think that game makes people salty? Because it makes me salty, too. And the learning curve's really high in that game, so a lot of the time you'll go up against people who will just destroy you. You'll just get completely annihilated.
It doesn't help that matchmaking is really bad. Didn't prestige in that game. You can level up individual characters to 20, and then you prestige, and you get, a little emblem and stuff, and then you do it again and again.
Yeah, Call of Duty style.
We had a full group of four. It's 4v4 game, and we're all ranked under rank 10 or whatever.
Yeah.
We haven't prestige or anything. Our item rank is down low. We're ranking, or we're being placed in matches against people who are, prestiged already and have a item store of 50. I think the maximum's 60 or 50 or
ours
something.
Is 10 or 15, theirs is 50, and we're just getting destroyed, and they have all their kill streaks, we have barely any.
Yeah. I mean, to be fair, it's a matter of get good, son.
Yeah.
We're not that good at it. But at the same time, why are you matching us with people who are already prestige? Yeah. That's not cool.
In that game, a lot of the fighting in that game makes you feel really cool. Really badass. So the reason I get salty anyway is because I'll be one-on-one with someone, feeling super cool. Then one of two things will happen. Either they're so much better than me and I can't even land a hit, so my dreams get dashed of being a badass. Or a second teammate of theirs just runs up from the side and kills me while I'm one-on-one.
Yeah, just cuts you in the back and you're dead. It's stupid. It's a good game, though.
Yeah, it is. It's a good game. It's well-designed and it's fun. They just need to work on the matchmaking.
Yeah. The combat system in that game is one of the,
most unique.
Yeah, unique and really, it feels full. It feels good.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's cool. Mm. Well, that's our For Honor segment. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah.
So again, thanks you guys for joining us. Quick, any updates on channel right now? Keep Tappin X brand.
We plan doing a second Let's Play.
Yeah, definitely some more shorter Let's Plays, because we know Final Fantasy IX is not. Yeah, it's
short.
Just a niche. It's a niche, and it's a very
long
Let's Play.
It's not everyone's cup of tea.
Yeah, exactly. It wasn't even mine until I was just man, I really want to play Final Fantasy IX.
All the Final Fantasy games are on sale on Steam, too.
Yeah, so check that out.
If anyone wants to buy them.
So it's a big Square Enix sale, so I think it's not even just Final Fantasy. It's Tomb Raider.
Yeah.
Deus Ex. Yeah.
I think Deus Ex, too, yeah. But yeah, we'll probably play a shorter game. Put it
Yeah, and this time Blake will be a part of it.
So. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So we'll probably, I don't know, there's a cool co-op bundle on Steam.
Yeah.
So might pick that up.
Do some couch co-op, have some fun.
Some couch co-op, yeah, exactly. On my...
Define couch.
Yeah. You know, it's tough because couch co-op is a weird thing these days where it's not
as
popular. It's actually its own
shout out platform. To Nintendo.
Yeah, it's its own kind of platform.
Yeah.
Now.
Yeah.
Which is kind of weird.
I'm always trying to find couch co-op games for me and my fiance to play because she doesn't have a good computer.
Yeah.
So and we can barely find anything.
Yeah, it's tough. And they're good. Luckily, there are good ones out there, but they're always really short too.
Yeah.
And I think it's. I have a game, you get a choice, right? It's couch co-op, exclusively couch co-op, or, online multiplayer, which is better. You should always have your game online no matter what in this day and age. I have a game, Samurai Gun, on Steam. It's amazing, not a co-op, but it's a party game where, you're just little 8-bit dudes, like, killing each other with swords and guns and stuff, and really fun, satisfying, just a good party game. But you can't play it online with friends. It's only couch co-op, local multiplayer. Yeah. That's so dumb. I don't get the logic behind that. I guess it's expensive to keep servers up, maybe.
I suppose, but it's whatever. Either way, if you're making an online, if you're making a co-op game, it should have online access.
Yeah,
that's the point.
But anyway, yeah. So look out for some couch co-op featuring Blake.
Wow. Look forward to it.
And
for all you Blake-a-maniacs out there,
Blake-a-mania is running wild.
I mean, I wasn't gonna make a Hulk Hogan reference, but.
You were thinking about it.
There's our Hulk Hogan reference for the week.
The quota.
Yeah.
So that's cool. And no other big updates. Just still
not to the channel.
Still waiting, still, you know, getting new art, overlays, end card for videos. Mm. Everything's been updating fine with iTunes, Google Play, stuff like that. So that's good.
It's good.
So Colby, let me ask you, what have you been playing
nothing
this week?
Nothing.
All right. Honestly, David, honestly, I mean, it's not true. I forgot when I went to work. Usually I bring Bravely Second with me, my off time, and I forgot it at home.
Piece of shit.
I went without playing that, which was a bummer, because now I'm like behind and I forgot where I am and stuff. So but that's an easy game to catch up on. I've played For Honor with David.
Yeah.
We streamed and stuff like that.
Played for about 4 hours.
Yeah, I played about 4 hours.
For Honor.
Four hours.
Okay.
Lots of fours there.
Yep, there's the pun.
Playing Forza next, right?
I just started. Well, Forza. Forza 5. No, we're going back. Forza 1.
Forza 4.
Forza 4.
There
Honor.
It is.
Forza For Honor.
Anyway, For Honor, yeah. That was one.
I started playing a little bit. I resubscribed to Final Fantasy 14.
Yeah, I played that a little bit with you.
Mm-hmm.
Did a dungeon.
Yeah, that was fun. Yeah. That's a weird game, because I don't remember anything about that game. I played that game, like, I don't know, when was the last time everybody played?
Years ago.
Yeah, it was like 2 years
before
ago,
before the expansion.
Yeah, before the Heaven's Sword expansion, which I got, because it was on sale on Steam, which was cool. So I got that. And they have this weird, really weird subscription, where it's like you get the normal subscription, which is like $15 a month, like typical subscription-based MMO. And then they have an entry subscription, where you pay like $2 less. And the only difference is that you can only have one character per server.
Yeah, it's really strange.
It's like $2 less. I'm like, it's so random. Such a random. So that's like what I did, of course.
13 a month instead of 15.
Yeah, but you know what's cool about that game is you only need one character, because every job/class in that game can be obtained with one character. You can switch between all of them.
Yeah, and you level just them up. Switch your weapon to switch classes.
Yeah, so. Which is really cool.
Did you say switch?
Yeah,
I thought that was dead. I thought that was a dead thing.
Nope,
apparently it's back.
Never die. I don't know. It's an MMO. Like do you, I guess I have that MMO itch that happens whenever somebody really gets into an MMO and it kind of never leaves your life. But I'm like six levels away from getting a dragoon. That's all I want out of life.
We can get you that dragoon class.
I know. I have Monday off. It's Monday's President's Day, and I got the day off work, so binge playing Final Fantasy, probably. So, cool.
But yeah, I'm definitely an MMO person, so whenever I'm not playing an MMO for a long time, I'm always like, which MMO should I resubscribe to? Is there any good free MMOs? Like, all that stuff.
There are a lot of free MMOs out there now.
Yeah, but I'm kind of... There's none that really stick with me.
No. I mean, I've played a lot of MMOs, too. Not nearly as much as you or Alex or anything, but... Yeah. I get really into it, and then once I discover what my class is about, if the questing isn't good, I'm done.
Yeah,
it's really what it is to me.
I'm more of an end game person.
Yeah,
there has to be stuff for me to do once I level. Mm-hmm. If there's not, then I'm just
I don't know. Like there's been many times where I remember the first time I got back into WoW, like really back into WoW, was when you, David, and all the friends over there were getting into it.
Yeah.
And keep the pillow there.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I rolled a warlock, the horde.
Yep.
And everybody was playing, everybody was into it and stuff, and I'm like, oh man, I gotta play. I didn't have a horde character then.
Yeah.
So I was like, oh man, I gotta level this guy up. That way I can get to the same level as my friends. I power leveled to level 63 from level 1.
Uh-huh.
This is before Legion, before I think it was during Mists of Pandaria.
Yeah, yeah.
And when everybody was into it. And then, I was just like, what am I doing? Like, I just stopped. I remember I was in the middle of Hellfire Peninsula.
Yeah.
And I was just like, I don't want to do this anymore. I can't do it anymore.
Yep.
And then everybody started leaving, and I was like, oh, come on, guys. I never even got to, like, do cool shit with you guys.
Yeah.
MMOs, I mean, I have to play, like, I don't know.
Every WoW expansion I level to max level, I get to the point where I'm raiding. Mm. I do the first raid, and I stop.
Yeah.
That's always the point where I stop.
Well, it's just, like, repetition for gear at that point. Yeah, yeah. It's, like, whatever.
Yep.
I don't know. That's kind of the same. Final Fantasy is weird like that, because you don't get gear that often in it.
Yeah.
But the gear is cool looking. I just got a new armor set, which looks really cool.
It is. And I like the raids have a lot more like cutscene and interactivity than the WoW raids.
Yeah.
So like it's fun, but there is fewer content and it's slower.
Yeah, I can't wait to see what more it'll bring. I mean, I'll play for a month. I only did it for a month, so, and then I canceled the subscription. So see how that goes. Other than that, I've been bad. I haven't played. I've just been busy, I guess. I haven't played anything.
Nothing at all.
No, you know what? I boasted last week. I was like, yo, I played Abzu. I beat XCOM, motherfuckers. Like,
and now it's nothing.
Now it's like it's just For Honor and Final Fantasy 14.
All right.
I think you're missing a game, Kobe.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Blake and I.
Fucking asshole.
Oh, I forgot about that. Listen, because we didn't finish it. That's why.
I know. I'm pretty sure we're close to the end.
Kingdom Hearts 0.2 is what they're talking about, I believe.
Actually, it's Kingdom Hearts 0.2 Final Chapter Prologue.
Final Chapter Prologue.
I think Birth by Sleep is in that title somewhere, too.
Yeah, so somewhere.
Yeah, Blake and I finally started that because every time we tried to plan it, there's been a blizzard or like a disease,
yeah,
a famine, a murder, I don't know, something.
So for those who don't know, Kingdom Hearts 0.2 is part of the 2.8 game.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it's like the bridging point between 2.8 and 3.
It's the last bit of story we're going to get before
that's Kingdom what they want you to say.
Yeah, that's what they think.
You play as Aqua after Birth by Sleep.
Yep.
Well, it's like 10 years after.
Yeah, yeah.
To her, it's nothing. Yeah. So, but I have thoughts about that, but I think we've all actually started playing that.
Yeah. I'm almost to where you are. I'm maybe like 10 minutes before where you guys are.
Yeah. So that's cool. We can talk about that on the same level. It's weird.
I have ups and downs about it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Do tell.
The combat's awesome.
Yes.
Combat's sweet. Mm. It's really smooth. It's pretty much Kingdom Hearts 2 combat, only better. Mm. They got rid of the command deck, which I'm happy about. Kobe said he didn't like.
It's not that I didn't like it. I was just surprised by it. Because I like it both ways. I like the command deck. I like the command deck, and I like the conventional Kingdom Hearts.
Like from Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2?
Yeah. Mm. I like both. I like the command, because I'm one of the few, like, I'm one of 10 people in the universe that like Chain of Memories.
I like Chain of Memories.
The card system.
I didn't mind Chain of Memories.
Yeah. Two of 10.
You mean re-Chain of Memories or, like, both. Vanilla?
I like both. Okay. I just like the card system because it doesn't change either way. I liked both. I like that. I like shifting between, like, abilities and stuff mid-match and then
getting into it.
Yeah. But again, I really like the other side, too. I think they really made it awesome in point two, because they added the reaction command spells into that, which are really cool, like Fire-ja, Thunder-ja.
So like when you cast Thunder enough, you get like Thunder-ja, and it's just like super Thunder,
which is OP. Like it's the most ridiculous move. It just destroys
everything,
and it looks beautiful.
It does. That game looks
Game does look amazing, and it's cool to see the Kingdom Hearts like characters and style like with the new updated graphics. It's cool to see.
What's a down?
Well, personally, I don't like, or it's not that I don't like it. I think it's weird that they have a costume thing.
Yeah, that was probably like all right, let's add one little thing. Oh, okay, we can just add some customized attire.
Maybe they were waiting for the teams to like finish the Unchained movie thing or something, and they were like, well, then again, I imagine the point two would take longer than anything else on that.
I mean, it's not like they show up in the cutscene either.
Yeah, I'm glad about that. But, so one thing the game has, like, you'll get objectives, and it'll be like, climb to the highest point in this map or kill this many things in a certain way, and you'll unlock like clothing, like an outfit for Aqua.
That's just to increase replayability, I assume, because it's kind
of
short.
I don't mind unlockables, and I like aesthetic changes, but like some of it just feels weird. Like one of the first things you get are cat ears.
Yeah.
And it's like, you have Aqua being like this super serious female protagonist, like that's still cat ears on her.
It's really funny because she like goes in, like, she's just like, everything is you know, in disarray and darkness and all that. And then, like, the cutscene fades away. And it's just her and, like, a tail and, like, cat ears. And it's just like,
so weird. And it just seems a little, like, it reminds me of, I was telling Colby, it reminds me of Lightning Returns.
Which I never played.
Yeah.
That's what I get the vibes from that. And it's just, I'm not feeling it. But, I'm
really feeling that.
Another thing that's a little weird to me is the movement seems a little clunky when you turn back and forth.
Like you commented on
yeah,
that.
Yeah, because like in the OG, you know, Kingdom Hearts and yep. 2, you could like, if you like spin the control stick like that.
Then you spin around.
Yeah, you spin around like mm-hmm. that. But like, now it's
what's
like.
What's that in this audio-based
like,
show?
It's kind of like, have you played GTA around. 4?
Yeah.
You know how like, you like, you know, you can't like
spin. It's
like
very
an
prevalent
idiot.
In modern games as opposed yeah. to back then when you were just trying to like clip behind yourself, right? And you were
yeah,
just like
yeah, yeah.
automatically turn like 180 degrees.
So now, like when you switch directions, your character actually has to switch directions. But in the really fast paced combat of Kingdom Hearts, it just seems a little clunky.
You think? I never had a problem to me. No. I thought the game was really smooth.
When you're pulling off combos,
I watched Kobe play, so I can't really comment on fighting people.
Mm-hmm.
I thought the combat felt really good, especially because flying enemies used to be like really like a hassle to take care of in previous Kingdom Hearts games.
They're not
they
at
fly
all
too high. No, in this one you just fly up to.
You
them,
just like double jump and swing mm-hmm. at them, and you just like lock
which
on.
Is really cool.
It's super easy.
It's not like a full game, right? Like, it kind of feels
it
like
feels
it's,
like
it's a piece of a greater
whole. It feels like a demo to me.
Yeah.
It feels like Kingdom Hearts 3 demo.
Yeah.
And I mean, I think that's the point,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
I also want to say the writing in Point 2 is probably the best writing in the series so far. Because, you know, Kingdom Hearts writing is kind of goofy, kind
of
like...
Heart of Darkness!
Yeah, like, Kingdom Hearts, Darkness, like,
yeah,
you know,
yeah.
and just
It's
whatever.
Really cheesy, but yeah.
But, like, Aqua's sort of, like... her dismay is actually kind of compelling.
I feel bad, bro.
Yeah
me too. Yeah. Like it's just the writing is really well done. The voice acting is really good in it, as always. You know, voice acting for Game Hearts has always been pretty good. It's
except Terra.
I'd have to replay Birth by Sleep, but yeah. all I see is like when like people talk about Birth by Sleep is how terrible the voice acting is for
Terra's voice actor was.
Well, to be fair, Aqua's voice acting in Birth by Sleep was really weird, not because of like her, maybe a little because of her, but it was also like the mixing was kind of weird.
Yeah,
she sounded kind of weird. I don't know if it was just me,
but in this it sounds good.
Yeah, it sounds good. And Terra sounds, I think he sounds really, Terra sounds really good.
Yeah,
in this game.
Yeah,
from the brief time we see him.
Good.
spoiler
whatever
you
expect. It's
you expect
Birth by Sleep, like quote unquote like sequel looking thing. Of course he's
in the trailer.
Yeah. Also, remix to Simple and Clean.
Awesome.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
So
opening,
good.
Oh, yeah, that's really good.
Opening cutscene.
Yeah, beast.
Beautiful.
It's overall, I really like, I like what they're doing with it. I like the direction it's going. I think the number one question to keep in mind is, like, does it make you excited for what Kingdom Hearts 3 can offer?
One of the main reasons I'm more excited for Kingdom Hearts 3 now is because it feels like Kingdom Hearts as a series is growing with its fans after playing this.
Mm-hmm.
Like, this is probably... Even though it's like a short kind of like demo-ish thing, it's the most like adult Kingdom Hearts thing we've gotten, if that makes sense to you.
Yeah,
like
definitely.
It's serious, it's dark, and like
it's keeping that T rating though.
yeah, no, definitely. But like you can tell that like it's for like an older generation.
It's matured.
Matured. Yeah,
and you know we'll see how much of that's you know by the we just came across Mickey. So like, who knows how that's gonna change? It's like, oh, here comes Disney! Like you know,
it needs its childish charm too. So
we saw Yen Sid earlier in his fucking big ass eyes.
Yeah.
That's true. He looks a little weird with the new graphics, in my opinion. But
everybody looks kind of.
It's a little jarring, but we're just gonna get used to it.
Yeah,
it's so good just to hear that music again, though. The Yen Sid's place, just like in a new game, you're just like, oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. Also, the battle, like the combat music.
Oh yeah.
Shimomura. Thank you.
He's doing work again.
Bless.
It's awesome.
Yeah, it's really good. I'm really enjoying it so far. I really want to finish it. Hopefully,
we'll finish it next week.
Yeah. I'm working Tuesday, by the way, Blake. I forgot to tell you. All
right.
I'm gonna have
I don't know. I think it might be early though, so I think I'll still be able to come over for 11. We'll see.
Okay. Well, let me know.
Make our plans on the podcast.
Yeah. Yep. That's it.
But I'm gonna have to replay it multiple times because there's unlockables you can only get in New Game Plus.
Mm-hmm.
So well, after we play it, I'm going to play by myself. Because I don't want to like play it before we finish it.
Are you playing it on Proud or Normal?
Just normal.
Yeah.
Proud's easy.
That's easy, what I thought. Easiest pie. Well, I mean, you start level 50. The enemies you fight aren't really that intimidating so far.
Yep.
I've come across one boss fight where I had a little bit of trouble.
I was just about to ask, what did you think about the final Aqua clone fight?
Oh, that was easy.
The last one?
I cakewalked it.
I had so much trouble on that fight.
Really? Maybe because I'm on normal.
Maybe, but like, there's no opportunity to attack her.
I just reflect.
That's what I ended up doing.
That's what you do. But that's what you do in Kingdom. That's what you do in Birth by Sleep.
Reflect took like 1/10 of our health bar.
Even whenever I counter and everything. Yeah. Really?
It was awful.
I mean, it seemed like you were.
I did it easy. Yeah. I don't know. Maybe. Better than.
Maybe. I had so much trouble.
I there was a fight after that. I had a little bit of trouble with, but it was fine. I mean, I beat it. It was with
the dark side or the
no,
or the I didn't want bunches to fight of anything. The bunches of bunches.
Yeah, the Demon Tower.
Yeah,
which is a weird name, but for a Kingdom Hearts enemy.
Yeah,
but like I had a little bit of trouble with that. Not enough to like die or anything, but I noticed my health getting low. But I mean, they give you everything in that game to just kick ass.
Yeah,
like you start off with Fire Girl Blizzard. It's cool they start you level 50. It
makes you feel strong.
Yeah, you're supposed to feel powerful. You're Aqua. It makes me wonder how they're gonna do Kingdom Hearts 3. Obviously, you're gonna start at level 1.
Yeah.
But like, how are they gonna like be like Sora? You suck again. Like, why do you lose all your magic again? It made sense like the second time, or in Kingdom Hearts 2, where you're just like, I was asleep for a year, getting all my memories like fucked with, so I have to relearn.
Maybe
magic.
It opens with like a boulder, just the boulder that was gonna connect with Sora.
No, it was gonna hit Mickey.
Was it Mickey?
Yeah.
Damn, not my lore doesn't connect yet. All right. Well, let's say in an alternate universe, it was gonna hit Sora, Goofy like. Push Sora out of the way, right? In this alternate.
Why can't just another rock come in?
Alright, another fucking rock is gonna hit Sora in the face. And then he's, oh no, I forgot everything.
That's it.
Boom.
Time to relearn fire.
Or maybe we play as Kairi.
Oh my god, can you imagine?
And know nothing.
Imagine how horrible that would be.
So like what we've seen so far is kinda like a MGS2.
Yeah.
Alright.
My god.
Or it's just a big ruse.
Yep.
Alright.
Do we have to play as Reiner?
Raiden.
Naked.
Do we play as Kairi.
Do we do somersault? do you play as Riku or Goofy naked somersaulting?
I'd hope so.
Man, Metal Gear Solid Revengeance, that was a game.
I remember watching my brother play that game. That was a great game. And as a kid, I was like, this isn't what video games are. What is going on?
That was a fantastic game.
Nah, that series sucks. Everybody knows it.
Anyway, we're getting off track.
And we're getting the zombie mode. Metal Gear.
Speaking of zombie mode, Resident Evil 7 DLC.
Yeah, so what else have you've been playing the Resident Evil DLC?
Yes, I played all the different branches of the DLC they have out right now, and there's quite a few.
Mm-hmm.
In the first pack came the bedroom DLC, which is an escape room. And you have to escape the room before the mom catches you. You have to solve all puzzles and get out of the room. It's not too hard. It takes about 20 minutes. I also played the nightmare mode, which is just a horde mode. You have to live for 5 hours, and every hour more things spawn. Jack, the dad, spawns twice, and he's like a boss. Not too hard once you figure out that you just upgrade your knife and melee everything, and you win.
Mm-hmm.
So I beat that a few times. And then Ethan Must Die was also in the first pack. That mode is the mode. So Ethan Must Die, you start on the outside of the main house, right outside the front door. And you just run into the house, and all you have to do is live and get to the end. Items spawn randomly in boxes, and the boxes have stars over them, with like 1 through 4 stars. The more stars, the better the item, and it's all randomized. And then when you die, your like body drops one of the items that you had for the next time you run through, so you can pick it up and get more items. That mode took me about 3 weeks to finally complete, like from the day the DLC came out to like a couple days ago.
Jeez.
That's how long it took me to beat it. And man, it's intense because everything one shots you. The entire house has like traps in it, even like more traps that weren't even in the main game, so you don't even know how they work, and you just have to like figure out ways around them. Then you have to like kill the mom at the end, but you have to kill her by like kiting her through all the traps because you barely have any ammo at that point. And it's really difficult. The run itself took me about 25 minutes. But I had so many countless runs just over and over.
Been releasing a lot of really varied DLC for that
game. Yeah, the second pack of DLC came out with Blackjack, a Blackjack game you play, but you have your hand in like a restraint.
A Chinese finger trap.
Yeah, pretty much. With all your fingers. And then you're up against another guy who also has his hand in a thing, and every time you lose a hand, it chops off a finger. and you have to
lose a hand, chop off.
Yeah.
It's like a pun.
You have to just live, and you have to have the other guy get his fingers chopped off before you, and then it gets more and more intense as it goes. You have to play tons of blackjack to finally finish it. You got like
go back. That's so random.
Yeah, it's really weird.
You know, Resident Evil.
Yeah. And then the other pack of DLC is even more random. It's the dad's 55th birthday, and you have to deliver him food fast enough before he gets angry at you, and there's all zombies and party hats trying to kill you. That is a really strange mode. You have to, like, pick up chicken and spice and combine them in your inventory and feed it to him.
You have to feed it to him?
Yeah, it's really weird.
Really, like, akin to old Resident Evil, though, that goofiness.
Yeah.
Which was the game? I think it was tofu. I was going to say the tofu costume. Yeah. That was Resident Evil 2, I think, right?
Yeah.
It's so strange. But I like it. Like, it's all varied game modes. Mm-hmm. And, like, it's worth the, like, $15 for DLC. And there's also, in the second part of the DLC, there's also a daughter's. It's called Daughters, and it shows, like, what happened to the family's daughter after, like, they went crazy. So it's actually a little story stuff, too. Mm-hmm. So it's really worth it, in my opinion, those DLC. It's really fun.
How much did you pay for those DLCs?
The first one was $10, the second one was $15.
Okay.
Or if you have the season pass.
I was about to say, was there a season pass?
Yeah, it was $35.
Of course. How many more are they releasing, packs-wise?
I'm not sure. I know they're coming out with the free DLC, which is the one you play as Chris Redfield.
That's the one I'm really curious about.
Yeah, but I don't know about the rest. I don't know how much more there's going to be after this one.
Interesting.
But they're all fun. They're all worth the time and money, in my opinion.
Do you think they'll feature Blake in a future DLC?
Fucking hope so.
He's such a big fan of
RE5. Firmly believe it.
Do you have to feed Blake?
is the Chris Redfield DLC, do you fight boulders?
Hopefully.
Oh, dude.
Coming at him from every angle.
Day one.
But he's not
Day
as one. Ripped anymore, so...
True.
Maybe he's off
haunted.
The gas.
He's haunted by them.
He's off the gas.
Yeah. He's more akin to his Resident Evil 1, like, original style.
Let's be real. He wasn't on gas. He was on diesel.
My apologies. My mistake.
There are a lot of people thinking it's not Chris Redfield, though. There's a huge conspiracy.
Fans
there.
But you said, is it not labeled Chris Redfield DLC?
It is. In the credits, it's labeled Chris Redfield.
Oh. Yeah.
And then, like, when you beat
it's
the
not
game...
Him.
Yeah, when you beat the game, it's, like, unlocked free DLC, and it's called Not a Hero, and it shows Chris Redfield with her in the assault.
The only reason people are so, like, hung up that it isn't is, one, it doesn't really look like him.
Yeah.
Two, he's in an umbrella helicopter, which is kind of weird. Like, a new umbrella helicopter.
Yeah, like a green... Like a blue and white instead of red and white umbrella. Yeah.
And three, he just... Did I say he just says I'm Redfield? Like no, he says I'm Redfield. Like, he doesn't say
maybe
I'm Chris.
It's his son.
Oh.
Unless, well, you said the credit says Chris Redfield.
It does say Chris Redfield.
Okay.
Legit just says Chris Redfield.
Who is it?
Plus, this game would have to take place like... He looks like he's as old as he is now.
In the game, there's a newspaper that says 16 years since Raccoon City.
Okay.
All the Resident Evil games take place in the year they came out.
Yeah that's right. Yeah. That one takes place in 2017.
Yeah.
So that's not... That wouldn't be...
And Resident Evil 5 was... I mean, Resident Evil 6 was 2012.
Yeah.
I mean, if he didn't punch boulders, I think maybe he had a kid at age like 10.
I don't know, maybe him and Shella got busy. I don't know.
Is that where she's been? Just in labor and like.
Yeah, she's just gone. She never
showed up.
She was
a super baby. Like, she was infected with Ouroboros.
But where's Jill?
Where's anybody?
I don't know.
Where is Jill?
Although
they're
coming out with the new movie.
Why was
an evil Vendetta?
Is that canon?
No.
It's not canon.
No. It's not.
Because it's
an abomination of everything Resident Evil.
Well, it might be an abomination, but if it's canon.
I don't think it's canon.
Okay.
It said it took place after Resident Evil 6, between 6 and 7.
Well,
so it might be canon.
All
right. It's to appeal to those action
Resident
Evil fans.
It's like Chris and Leon and all them.
I'll take more Leon.
Yeah. I'll probably watch it. It'll probably be horrible.
Wait, is it the live action?
No.
It's
I thought you were talking about those. I was like,
no.
Shut
that's
up.
Done with
those
now.
Are terrible.
No, they're coming out with a new CG one.
Okay.
Yeah.
With Chris and Leon. Yeah. And Claire's in it, too, which is interesting. Mm. But she gets kidnapped, so she's probably just...
Isn't Claire in Revelations? Or my...
Yes, Claire.
Yeah, okay. I still got to play that.
She hasn't appeared in anything else.
No.
Revelations 2,
That and Zero.
Revelations 2 is a weird thing, because it's like, it's canon, but it doesn't matter.
Well, it's like it
Don't spoil it. I hear it's good.
Oh, okay, I won't say anything.
It's pretty good.
Because I read up on the lore too.
Fucking asshole.
I played them.
Yeah, I don't play Resident Evil games. I watch them.
Yeah.
So I'm a little bitch.
Okay, if you're ever gonna play Revelations 2, do not play it alone. Play it co-op.
Yeah, I was gonna make my cousin buy it.
You will get demolished if you play it alone, because the AI is horrible.
Mm.
So
cute.
Is it couch and online co-op?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Right. I play couch.
Okay.
Anything else you've been playing? Oh, I'm sorry. Did you have more to say about?
Oh no, no.
Mold monsters.
I played a little bit of Final Fantasy 14 and For Honor with you.
Yep.
I played a little bit of Pillars of Eternity DLC.
Oh yeah, you're playing that last night, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
It's pretty fun. You know, it's more of the same. If you like Pillars of Eternity, you'll like the DLC.
I got so into that, into the first level, and then, man, I just dropped it. That game's too big for me right now.
It's huge.
I can't do
it. It's one of my favorite games of all time.
How many hours did you put into it?
121 in the main campaign.
Jesus.
And you want to know what level I was?
What?
12.
What the fuck?
Out of what?
One out of, I don't know. I don't know
how high it goes. 100, probably.
I'm still getting experience. But that's one level per 10 hours. So this is a slow-paced game. But once you're into it, it just sucks you in.
Yeah,
you're in the world.
That's like, it's totally my jam too. Cause it's just it's like a tabletop
dungeon. It's legit playing D&D.
Yeah, man. But you didn't name your allies too, right?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
I need to reach.
Though those. I didn't because they're such distinct characters.
Yeah,
that I like. True. I liked those characters. Amazing voice acting. You know, the first ally you get is Matt Mercer.
Oh,
and then so it just good. It's keep equally as good from them. Yeah.
Anything else?
No, I'm sorry. I could just rant about Pillars of Eternity.
Yeah, I know. I know you're good.
So much. But I haven't really played much else.
Second one, the Kickstarter, reached its goal in like an hour.
Made 2 million in a week.
Yeah, in a week.
So
good for that.
Very excited about that.
That's going to be pretty hype.
Mm-hmm.
But Blake.
Yes.
What have you been playing?
Well, besides that, like 3 minutes of Kingdom Hearts I played. When I was like, hey, I want to fiddle with the controls.
I was literally like, here, you were like, I want to fiddle with it. And I gave it to you. And that was it.
Yeah, I mean, that was it. I said 3 minutes.
You casted Blizzard, did the whole grind on the rail thing, and done.
It's cool.
Did you get the objective to like do the long grind?
No, we haven't looked at the objectives.
No.
We're just doing it for the story right now.
Okay, that's probably what I should do. Because
we're playing it together, so we don't have a lot of time together to play it.
Yeah.
So.
Together! For all you SpongeBob fans out there.
None of you.
Well, yeah, I know.
Have you played more Dragon Ball?
I have played Dragon Ball Fusions. In fact,
whoa.
I played a lot of more Dragon Ball Fusions for the Nintendo 3DS.
How many hours would you say you have into this game?
Let's find out.
Let me open my Nintendo 3DS and go into my activity log and find out.
Okay.
Until then.
So, Dragon Ball Fusions, I'm really enjoying it.
Okay. He's padding for time.
Yes. it's really fun.
Don't bail him out, David. Let him go on his own.
Trying to... Alright, so the application is loading. Alright. Wow, software library. Let's see.
Do you do Let's Plays like single?
Shut up. I played 24 hours and 48 minutes so far.
That's very impressive for you, Blake.
Yeah, I know. I played it 14 times so far, and my average play time was an hour and 46 minutes.
Right, thank you.
Alright. So, Dragon Ball Fusions. I think I'm closing in on the end of the story.
That's a long... I wasn't expecting a campaign that long. Have you been, like, fucking around?
I've been fucking around. I've been doing, like, side quests and, like...
Have you fallen asleep with it on yet?
No. Oh. Because it doesn't include playtime when it's in sleep mode.
Oh, okay.
So, technically,
they
yes.
They got you.
But technically, no. Yeah. So, I've been playing it, it's interesting because, like, the main, like, the first, like, team you have is, like, the team, like, even if you swap out characters, they're, like, they interact with, the like, all the story elements. So, like, it's you, Kid Goku, Goten, Kid Trunks, and Pan from GT. And they all interact with, like, story elements, even if, like, none of them are in your party.
All right.
Like, those are, like, the main dudes that, like, interact with the story. And, like, when you do side quests, like I found Bardock, and, like, Kid Goku's like,
sup?
Hey, you look, like, familiar. And then, like, Bardock, like, realizes it's fucking his son. And he's like, oh, he doesn't want to, like, tell him. It's like, hey, I'm your father.
Yo, sup?
Then he's like, you know, fight me! And then, like...
Yeah, because that's better.
And then, like, we beat Bardock, and then, like...
We did it.
Then you recruit him on your team.
That's cool.
Yeah, so my current team is my avatar, an EX fusion. I'll explain that in a sec. An EX fusion of Goten and Trunks. So it's EX...
Street Fighter over here.
Yeah, really.
EX Gotenks. So it's, you know, I don't know, like, if everyone knows what Gotenks looks like, but it's, like, it's not, it doesn't look like Gotenks. It's like a different version.
Nega
like,
Gotenks.
Yeah, it's hard to explain.
Bizarro Gotenks.
Bizarro. Yeah, it kind of looks, it's like a different take on like what That's they cool. would look like.
Yeah.
So EX Fusion, like somewhere in like the fourth world or whatever, Bulma mentions that like, oh, I created EX Fusion. So it's basically you wear these armbands and you do the fusion dance, and but there's no time limit, and you can when you if you take off the band, yeah, then the fusion's over.
Okay.
So all it's permanent, right, until you want to take it off.
Okay.
And
freaking Bulma bailing, yeah, out.
So like, so you can EX fusion like almost any character, Hercule, but like Goku. there's specific like requirements. Like there's like if you go to where you EX fusion, like it would say like which characters, even if you don't have them unlocked, they can only fuse with like specific people. Like Hercule can only EX fusion with Fat Boo.
What? Yeah, really?
But no, you can also do like regular like fusion dances and yeah, like, but like they're like in battle,
right?
Like if you have Goten Trunks and you have enough ki,
you can,
yeah, then you can like fusion dance and, you know, SS3 and all that good stuff. So my current team is my avatar EX Gotenks, base form Bardock, final form Cooler.
Whoa, cool.
Who's like a monster.
Nice. I love
him. And base form Future Trunks.
Nice. Yeah, of course.
I had to get him on the team. He's not that good.
That sounds like a cool team though.
But like, cool like team. I'm hoping like, cuz I know he has like a Super Saiyan variant and a Super Saiyan 3 variant for, ooh, some reason. Huh. So I'm like,
surprised he doesn't have like forward to that. The super variant too maybe.
Yeah, that's in the DLC.
Okay.
Which we'll get to later. So all right. So Dragon Ball Fusion is fun, but I have a big issue with it, but it's not the game's fault. It's the localization censored something. I mentioned this to Kobe when I saw him earlier in the week.
Is the dialogue a little wonky?
No, the dialogue's fine. They said like, I don't understand like the censorship because, so they censored swords in the game.
Yeah.
What?
So instead of a sword, you have a long, brown, undefined, like, stick. It's weird. It makes no sense. And, like, they say, like, hell and damn it and, like, damn and, like, you'd think they'd censor that if they wanted to censor anything.
Nope.
But, all right.
Can't have swords.
I heard about this before, like, it got released. And I was like, all right, that's weird, but maybe it doesn't apply to, like, actual, like, Dragon Ball characters that actually have swords.
Yeah.
Like Trunks, for example.
The sword was in the anime.
Yeah.
Even the Funimation version, right?
Yeah.
Even like the
it was that version. They didn't censor swords.
And like, I don't understand it because like, I'm like, all right, Future Trunks, I use a sword attack.
Yeah.
And he has a fucking stick. And we're going to get to this when we...
But he has the hilt of his sword.
No. So in the DLC that came out, one of the characters is... Trunks from Dragon Ball Super, so with the blue hair,
yeah,
and his like character model has like a sheathed sword on his back, and if you and like I was like, all right, maybe like this will be the exception.
Yeah,
I use a sword attack. He has a stick.
He just pulls out his like normal sheath that is just a wooden.
No, it's just like on his back, like still sheathed, and he just has like.
And that
a
is a localization
stick.
Issue. Like they have the sword in the Japanese version.
Yeah, and what? I don't know if like the European version is censored, but like I guess like. Bandai Namco was like, well, you know, we just decided to censor it. I was like, why?
Like,
this is like, it's not like any other Dragon Ball game ever has censored swords. They have guns in the game.
Yeah. Wait, and do they have guns in that game?
I'm pretty sure. I all I've seen so far is like Jocko's like laser gun.
Yeah.
And it makes no sense. And
that's goofy.
That's ridiculous.
Like, I just fought, like, Deborah, and you know how he has a giant-ass sword?
Yeah.
Fucking use the sword attack stick. I'm like, this is so stupid. Ugh, it's frustrating.
That's really lame censorship. That's like as bad as the censoring the guns in One Piece.
Or Yu-Gi-Oh.
Yeah, where they just fucking point.
The finger guns.
Yeah.
Hold it right there.
In One Piece, they're pirates.
Yeah,
they don't let them have guns.
Nope. We're family-friendly pirates.
It makes no sense. And I don't remember if it... I think it's, like, E10, but, like, it's just a fucking sword.
Yeah. Swords are in, like, everything.
And, like, and it's not like it's all, bloody. Like, chibi style. Yeah, there's no blood or anything.
Yeah.
It makes no sense. And...
Tell me I can't, like,
I'm not a fan of that. Someone. Like, that's, like, the one, like... Great. Like, blemish on this great game. And it's not the game's fault, either.
Yeah.
And...
I think it is.
It's the developers.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, screw you, Bandai.
It's disappointing.
Yeah, that really sucks.
That sounds like something you'd see in, like, a German release, right? Like, a country that, like, is really weird with their censorship of games. Not an American release.
Yeah. Whatever. Seems a little strange.
Like, maybe if there was, like, precedent, like, other Dragon Ball games, but it's not. It's, I don't know. It's weird. Not a fan.
Next, they're going to censor key blasts.
Yeah.
Because they're explosive.
Make them like basketball. Just
like turn Dragon Ball Z or Dragon Ball into a basketball
game. Basketball game.
Yeah.
NBA Street.
NBA DBZ
NBA
Street.
NBA Street is fantastic.
Great game. No, it's a great game.
Oh, so good, dude.
The last great one.
Did you know the starting Which NBA Street have you played? Have you played Volume 1, 2, and 3?
Oh, God.
Or just like one of them?
Just one of them. Okay. I was a kid. I don't know.
I have all three. They're so good.
Which is the one with Mario?
That's three.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yep. Speaking of which, they're esports. You know, like MLG, whenever it's coming out with an esport for a division for NBA games.
So, for all
you sports fans out there, that's pretty cool.
So, is that the first, like,
I think it's the first esports.
Esports.
That's interesting, actually. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, so I mean, hope that gives some like validity to like.
I'm surprised, honestly, it wasn't FIFA, because FIFA's huge.
FIFA's the big one too. Yeah, I don't know. I guess NBA was just like, let's jump on that.
Yeah, that's cool.
But anything else about fusions?
I really like it.
It's a great game.
I'll probably beat it by the time I talk about it next, whenever that may be.
Cool.
And then you'll be playing another game, probably not.
Yeah, we'll see. I'm working on it.
Anything else you?
I have to get my cousin to buy Resident Evil 6, and then we can start playing that.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Any other games you've been playing?
Nope.
All right, we're good.
That's that.
So that's all we've been playing. Man, we suck.
Yeah, we're awful.
Nothing new.
We're the
worst. Listen, guys, I'm waiting for my Humble Bumble monthly to
Humble Bumble. Yeah, I'm playing Resident Evil 7 DLC. That's new. That's new releases.
It's not.
It just came out like last week.
Resident Evil 7.
The DLC is new.
I got it. I'm kidding. But that's okay. Wow. We haven't been playing new franchises.
Yeah.
Well, it's a shame because of all these new releases this past week.
Like what, Blake?
Well, we have Deformers. Who played that?
Nope, I didn't play it.
All right. For Honor. I haven't played it, but you guys played it. You all talked about it.
I talked about getting wrecked.
All right. Yeah. Who played Ride 2?
I didn't play Ride. I never played the first one either.
Platinum. Yeah.
Whoa.
I haven't.
Yeah, it's for the PS4, Xbox. I was going to say, it's like, all right. I was going to catch you. And then Sniper Elite 4.
I watched some gameplay of that.
Oh, yeah?
That's pretty cool. Let's do a co-op.
Do you snipe?
Exclusively.
Do you exclusively snipe?
You at an elite level.
Ooh.
Damn.
The only thing I know about the game is that there's like a season pass.
That doesn't say much.
That's like every single game.
It takes place in like World War II, but in Italy, which is cool.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Fuck it. Anyways.
Let's play Sniper Elite 4.
Yep, that's it. Keep playing
on YouTube.
That's our next Let's Play.
Yeah. You know,
Sniper Elite 4. What else?
So you wanna... Well, that's it for new releases.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah.
Huh. Oh, wow.
That's why we haven't been playing new games.
Okay, well, that was easy. So, yeah, I mean, we played For Honor, and that's it on the list there.
I mean, there's a lot of news this week.
Yeah. Lots.
All right, well, let's dig into it,
boys. Just bang it, getting right into it.
It's just bullet points.
Bullet points.
Bang right into it. Let's go. Bang right. Bang.
Yeah.
So, there was a big Pokemon Go update.
Yeah.
Yep. So, I thought they'd wait till the summer.
Me too.
Honestly,
that would have been the smart move.
Not fucking in this cold ass weather.
Let's release a new generation of Pokemon when it's 20 degrees out.
I mean, I don't think it's 20 degrees everywhere, but mostly everywhere.
Well, it's like isolating the entire like North America. East Coast.
Yeah.
But is it second gen? Is it just like
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's 5 newer things in the new Pokemon Go update. So first, there's additional Pokemon, more than 80 Pokemon that from the Johto region.
80 of them Pokemon.
80 of them Pokemons.
Are in the game.
Yeah.
Along with gender specific variations.
Yep.
Because there was no genders in the base Pokemon Go, right?
Yeah. There were.
Do they have surfing Pikachu?
They do not.
I'm not getting it.
I mean, we saw fucking Santa Hat Pikachu, so maybe in the summer they're like, Cowabunga Pikachu or something.
Oh, yes. The Ninja Turtle Pikachu. Yeah.
Cowabunga, dude.
Cowabunga, man.
So, this goes without saying, but there's new evolutions.
Yep.
Like, if you have a Scyther, you have to get the Metal Coat item and then, like, some amount of candy, and then you can evolve into Scissor.
Caesar.
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 Caesar. Look, it's Caesar.
not Caesar. Caesar. Yeah, Caesar. Julius Caesar is in this
game.
Damn. Pretty powerful Pokemon.
He ruled a nation.
One of the bullet points is new encounter gameplay, whatever that means. So it says, I'm just going to read it because I don't know what it means. when you encounter Pokemon in the wild, don't be surprised if they react in new ways as you're trying to catch them. You'll also notice the addition of new item carousels that allow you to select berries and Pokeballs directly from the encounter screen. Hone your skills and catch those elusive Pokemon.
They probably take a dump when you see them.
So they updated the UI is what it sounds like in battle, and they made the Pokemon like air hump when they see you or something. I don't know.
I'm gonna say maybe on that.
Can I see Caesar air hump?
Julius himself. there's also new berries, nanab berries and pinap berries. Nanab berries will slow the Pokemon's movements, making it easier to catch, and pinap berries doubles the amount of candy you'll receive if your next catch attempt succeeds.
Slows their movements? There's only like one opportunity where they like jump up.
They like
and
jump
can't
up and down.
Them.
Yeah.
Well, you'll do it in slow motion now.
Yeah, I choose you.
Also, there's new avatars and an expanded wardrobe, so you can customize more better, I guess.
But they didn't fix the tracking system or the battle system.
Probably not. No,
no trading.
See,
that's coming. Online trading in like one on one, like PvP. I think that's
You know what's a mistake releasing it in the winter? Everybody's in school.
Yeah.
Yep.
But does it cold is only a factor in certain regions.
What about summer camp and summer classes?
They have Pokemon summer camp now.
What about Australia?
Yeah.
What about Australia?
It's warm there.
Yeah, they can literally fight till the ends of the year with anything because they're tough down there.
You're talking down.
I just complimented
almost 80%. Shut up. 80% of our fan base.
Australia.
The Aussies. Shout out to the Down Under.
Is that a
racial? No, it's not. No, it's not.
It's not.
Is it?
What?
Aussies? No, I think that's good,
Aussies?
Right?
Aussies.
It's not derogatory.
Aussies?
Yeah. Aussies. Yeah. Aussie and Drix.
Aussie and Drix.
So that's the Pokemon Go update.
Yeah,
I think they should have waited.
Yeah, should have waited till summer.
Because it's not like it had any momentum.
I was going to say, it's not like the hype.
They could have probably waited.
Yeah.
Maybe throughout before the summer months, implement the online trading.
Sure, gave themselves a few more months.
PvP
I do have to say though, good on them for updating with such a big update after the game essentially died.
Yeah, that's true. The developer could have.
I mean, we say it died, but it's still grossing millions.
Which is strange
because
you don't see anyone playing anymore.
I know.
But
it's weird.
There's still
I know
a lot of people playing it.
One
apparently.
Person in our friend group that plays it.
Yeah.
And he'll play anything.
Yeah.
I know a bunch of dudes that I follow on Twitter that still play it regularly.
Really?
Fucking nerds.
I mean,
I'm
whatever.
Kidding.
I mean, we can talk about playing
I love you
Kingdom
guys.
Hearts all the time.
That's true.
Yeah, I know.
Which is an actual game, but.
Yeah, I wish Pokemon Go was still as big as it used to be. This is fun.
I probably still wouldn't play it.
Me either.
Is that okay?
But it was fun.
Yeah, well, fuck you, Blake. Don't fuck that.
Wow.
All right, what's next? Pokemon Go.
No.
Pokemon Go.
Yeah, go to the next bullet point.
Am
I right, fellas?
That segue.
Yeah, you too, pal.
What the fuck is
that? Gone.
The Hordes of Mordor.
So this was announced. For Honor. Listen, I'm trying to talk, you fucking
right,
asshole.
No, sorry. Yeah,
right,
yeah.
All right.
So David, what are you up to? Let's not split.
So this was announced when we were recording last week. So this on February 13th, you know, obviously that already happened. We got Dragon Ball Fusions got a free update that that made it so you can have online battles with friends or strangers. Mm-hmm. So you can, you know, PvP.
Cool.
You can trade special moves. So like in the game, you after like you can get like special moves you can teach. It's like.
To, like,
think Pokemon.
You like equip them with the abilities.
Yeah, like it's like you only have three move slots.
Yeah.
And like, you know, there's like you like there's like say you have the Kamehameha, and there's like different variations. Like there's like different like you can get like two different Kamehamehas, but like one's stronger. So you just like teach it over the old Kamehameha. All right, so yeah, you can trade special moves. And there's new characters, new fusion possibilities. So the new characters. So there's these are all from Dragon Ball Super. So there's Dragon Ball Super Future Trunks, and there's a Super Saiyan variant. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, there's Goku Black. Mm-hmm. There's a Super Saiyan Rosé, Goku Black.
Rosé.
There's a Super Saiyan Blue Vegito. There's a Zamasu and there's Fused Zamasu. But it's interesting. That Zamasu and Fused Zamasu are called Zamas. So that might be their dub name.
Yeah, I guess so.
Perhaps. Yeah. Instead of Zamasu.
Zamas.
I mean, like during the series, they were kind of switching off. Like sometimes they'd call him Zamasu, and like they some think, others would call him Zamas.
In the Japanese language, when a word ends in su, that's su, the u is usually silent. So it's
probably. But they're like calling him like. It
sounds
two
like,
different
sounds like a sauce.
In the,
Zamas.
Yeah. Zamas.
Mm, yeah. I made a nice Zamas sauce. Made a nice Zamas.
In addition, when you like get a new character, you can like buy their clothes and like you can customize your avatar.
Mm-hmm.
So you get all the characters I just mentioned, their clothes. The new special moves are the final Kamehameha.
Surprised I wasn't Vegito's in the base move. Game.
I know.
The Vegito's.
Vegito.
At least a Vegeta.
Not Vegeta.
Yep.
Divine Wrath, which is Zamasu's move.
Zamas, please.
Zamas. My bad. Light Sword, which is Trunks's, I assume, is Spirit Bomb Sword.
Yep.
And there's the Black
But will it be a Spirit Bomb Sword or a Spirit Bomb Stick?
Oh, fuck.
Fuck, dude.
Wow. They're ruined. It's probably going to be like a Beam of Light, which they'll probably keep.
Yeah. Hopefully.
It's a giant.
I don't know. I haven't encountered the movie.
It'll just be a normal stick. This is like one of the sword moves.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Literally like a tree branch.
Yeah.
And also the Black Kamehameha, which is a Goku Black's moves.
Yep.
So you get after you update, you get all these characters. Like you don't have to recruit them. You just get them, and you can like put them in your party. They're super OP, and I didn't want to use them, so I'm not using them until I get into the post game
because
they're way too strong.
But how humble.
Yeah.
What a nice guy.
Dragon Ball Fusion DLC. It was free, and
free DLC is
I'd be okay
free
with...
Free DLC is great.
Yeah, maybe it gets another update like down the line with stuff from the Universal Survivor arc.
That'd be cool.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
It's, yeah.
Because I know it has like the Universe 6 characters and stuff, so I had all that covered. But yeah.
Bangarang.
Yeah. Bang, next one.
Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy got a release date.
I'm pretty hyped. I used to play Crash.
I was gonna
a
say,
lot.
What are your guys' history with the Crash?
I
series?
Played the first three.
Well, I haven't even said when it's releasing.
When is it releasing?
So I think you should wait.
When is it releasing?
June 30th. Continue.
All right.
No, now we're gonna wait till June 30th.
All right.
Yeah, I used to play Crash all the time, and it was too difficult for my like 9-year-old brain to comprehend.
I'm on that boat.
Yeah.
I remember my mother used to work at a community center thing, so she would bring me in, and like they had a PS1 there.
Yeah.
And like one of the only games they had was Crash Bandicoot, so I played that there, and I'm like, I don't get this at all.
Yeah.
Like, you know, dumb Colby, dopey, dumb idiot, stupid, freaking big teeth, fucking motherfucker, 10-year-old Colby. Actually, I don't remember how old I was, but we'd play that.
Yeah. Crash whooped my ass when I was a kid.
I played zero of Crash, and I'm going to use this as an opportunity to play Crash.
Really what, you don't want to start with Skylanders? He's in.
Anyways.
they were like runners. They were old school runner games. That's really all they were.
Kind of, yeah.
Yeah.
But it was like some action.
You just ran also, either towards or away from the screen, spun around, broke boxes, and jumped over crates.
Yeah, it's all platforming.
Yeah. Also, Skyline just got canceled.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Mm-hmm. You know, those games actually weren't that bad.
Yeah.
The Skyline
I heard they weren't that bad. I'm surprised they got canceled. Weren't they just like a cash cow?
I know they're not coming out cash. With a new mobile game this year, but I'm pretty, the console variant got.
Wow. I guess Amiibos beat them out.
I don't even think Amiibos are that. I don't know.
Not anymore.
I guess they're still popular.
They were more popular than they are now, but.
Well, because, they were releasing, the Smash line. And right. And, I mean.
It's Smash that sold them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Smash, the Amiibo are coming out.
Nintendo just needs to. Nintendo needs to focus more on Smash. Smash really draws in customers. Every time.
Well, I'm assuming E3 we're going to get a definitive edition for the Wii U version.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah, that's true. In their direct.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So,
fuckers. Next.
So, Microsoft announced the Xbox E3 conference date. So, this is interesting because it's on Sunday. At 2 p.m. PT? What's the
Pacific
PT?
Time?
Pacific time. Yeah, I was like
the demo of PT.
No, so that's 5 p.m.
Yeah.
Eastern Standard Time. Yeah. This is interesting because it was always Sunday morning.
Yeah.
No, Sunday morning. Monday morning at noon.
Yeah.
So
they changed it, which is interesting. But
I was like, why? Like, this is in the middle of the day. You know, I'm probably going to be working.
Yeah, it's a bad time.
I'm
not too excited, honestly, for work, though.
I'm
not even that hyped.
I mean,
You're a bigger console gamer than us, Blade.
Yeah, but I always, watch it, I live tweet it. It's
an Xbox or is it Microsoft?
No, it's the Xbox E3 conference.
Oh, okay. It's Microsoft, but it's E3, so it's Xbox.
Yeah. If it's Microsoft, then you hear a little more about the Windows Store, which is the worst thing ever.
God, no. No, anything involving the Windows Store is just bad.
I guess I'm there's another conference happening on Sunday too. A lot of them are moving to Sunday.
That's strange.
People are theorizing that it's maybe because E3 is going public again.
Oh, maybe.
And they don't want to interfere. I don't know. They don't want to clash.
Do you think Sony's will be on Sunday too?
I mean, usually it's on, it's usually Monday night. Yeah. Right?
But maybe it'll be Sunday night now. Maybe.
Or maybe they want the day to themselves.
Yeah. Who knows?
You know, they just want to take the day off, kind of chill out, relax. You know, it's been hard on them all the year.
But, I don't see any big announcements coming from E3 this year. So
It's too early to tell, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Which is, you have Scorpion or Scorpio.
Oh, I guess they have that.
Yeah, they're going to talk about Xbox. Project Scorpio.
Yeah.
Which is probably $1,000 Xbox.
Yeah. What do you think that's going to be?
It's gonna be the
they
PS4
probably
Pro.
Saw the pro yeah. they saw the price on the PS4 Pro and they're like, shit, yeah, we can't do it this low.
To be fair, didn't PlayStation do that, reverse, they overpriced their PlayStation 3?
Yeah.
$599 US.
God, yeah. Imagine if you paid $600 for a PS3 today.
Nope.
No,
no way.
Joke.
Yep.
But hey, whatever. Remember the original looking PlayStation 3 controller they had? Yeah, that thing was disgusting.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
It was silver and like
I remember that.
But I don't know. I mean, I don't really see a lot of big announcements from E3 from the big guys. Maybe we'll learn more about Cyberpunk from
CD Projekt Red.
If they're there. Would be cool. Probably not.
Yeah.
I don't know. What do you think, Blake?
I mean, I could see them when did Halo 5 come out?
I've followed Halo forever.
A year ago, 2 years ago?
A while ago, yeah.
Whatever. maybe we can get more information on Scalebound.
Oh, yeah. They're bringing it back. The resurgence.
We fooled you.
I want a new Devil May Cry.
That'd be cool.
So bad.
Maybe more on Death Stranding.
That would be on Sony's conference.
I'd
be hyped for that.
Well, I'm saying I'm talking about E3.
Oh, okay. In general.
I'd be hyped for that.
I mean, I could see Kingdom Hearts. I mean, we said this last year, But Kingdom Hearts at Sony's presser.
Maybe.
I know, oh, you know, it'd be interesting if Microsoft is all about VR, like if they came out with their own headset, because they're the only ones. Well, I mean, Nintendo maybe. Doesn't, but yeah. Sony came out with theirs, so maybe with Scorpio, they're kind of like, VR ready, and here it is. It's like their Google Cardboard.
There's no games for VR. Oh, yeah, that's actually something I want to talk about. There's Valve said they're making 3 full VR games. Oh,
yeah, that's right.
Yeah, I saw that.
Which is pretty interesting.
I didn't write it down in the notes.
No details on it.
No details at all. But if they make fully fledged games that are VR, like if they make like a Portal-esque game made for VR,
it's down, kind, of, so kind of concerning that they're making 3, because I'm wondering the quality of that.
They'll never make it to the third game.
They'll never make it. Yeah, true.
Like that's also a question: is it 3 like a trilogy
or separate games?
Yeah, because like I don't know. I mean, because they made good games. I mean, people still play Left 4 Dead and well, you know, Half-Life. Somehow they still play
Portal.
That game.
They make Portal. They Portal. Yeah.
Seriously,
their games still hold up.
Yeah, they do. They do hold up pretty well.
Team Fortress 2.
Yep, that's right. Team Fortress 2 is still popular. Yep. So, I don't know. VR, that's cool, though. I mean, hopefully they do well, because VR needs more.
VR needs more games.
Yeah.
It's too expensive to, like, just play, like, RE7
on. I'm not paying $800 for, for like, a horror game simulator thing on VR. For horror games, I am never going to play ever.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I agree.
Next.
So, Nintendo announced that Splatoon 2 is getting a global test fire March 24th through the 26th, 1 weekend only, although they said that about Splatoon 1's global test fire, and that happened 3 times, or like twice or whatever.
Yep.
So it's 6 special 1-hour play times. So on the 24th, it's 12 o'clock to 12:59 p.m.
Only for an hour?
Yes.
That's weird.
I mean, they did it for the same thing for the first global test fire. Still like weird. For the first Splatoon. I mean, Nintendo never does betas. This is just them being Nintendo.
Yeah, yeah. True.
Yeah, I wonder if that's gonna be show after the first beta. It's just like, well, I was gonna play an hour of Splatoon, but for the first like 25 minutes, the servers are crashed.
So
it's 12 o'clock to 12:59 p.m. Pacific time. And 8 o'clock through 8:59 p.m. Pacific time. So that's the 24th. 25th is 4 o'clock to 4:59 a.m. Pacific time. So that would be 7 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. Yeah.
The 3 hours
behind. And then it's the 12 o'clock to, and 8 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. And on 26th, it's only at 4 o'clock to 4:59 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. So yeah.
A.m.?
Get hype. Yeah. So it'd be like 7 in the morning.
Yeah. Okay, sure.
They're probably working off of like the Japan
schedule.
Yeah. Probably.
Yeah.
So get hype for that Splatoon player.
And obviously this is like, I mean, it's free, you know,
if you're awake and want to play Splatoon.
Yeah. I mean, I played a little bit of the Global Test Fire on Wii U.
Yeah.
It was all right. I didn't buy Splatoon.
That doesn't seem like your jam anyway.
Yeah, but like a lot of people were
like,
playing.
I only know like one person who bought Splatoon. They played it for like a month and then stopped.
Well, shut up.
Nobody even talks about Splatoon anymore.
Yeah. So
you'd be surprised.
That's true.
I probably would be.
You live in a different world than us, Blake, when it comes to.
What are you trying to say, huh?
You racist fucking weeb.
Okay.
No. Thanks. I'm more of a weeb than you. Wow. I watch anime. But yeah, well, what's next then? Splatoon. For all you Splatoon fans, all 30,000 of you in our chat.
Yep.
Also, Splatoon 2 will have 8-player LAN play.
That's
so you
cool.
can create local private battle tournaments without needing an internet connection.
Local battle tournaments.
Local private battle tournaments.
That's their talk in that line.
That's
jargon.
Yeah,
jargon.
That's definitely a term.
So that's pretty cool.
Yep.
I wish they would like make Kirby Air Ride like 2 or something and have it, because I know Kirby Air Ride had LAN play.
Mm-hmm.
And like, I mean, I obviously never had an
Kirby Air Ride with a local private battle tournament.
Yes. That specific thing.
I just want a local battle city trials.
Yeah.
That was the best part of that
game. I mean, you could do LAN play of regular racing or a city trial or the top down, top ride or whatever.
We'll never get it.
Yeah.
F-Zero.
Local.
We don't talk
with
about
an LPBT.
LP sounds like a new
local private
LGBT
battle tournament.
Sort of community.
LPBT.
LPBT.
Yeah, yeah.
KY.
That's the new term.
MICKEY. MOUSE. Next.
You spell it Mickey Mouse?
Mickey Mouse.
Go on, keep it going.
Right, come on, Mouse. It's here. Go.
All right. So on August 15th, 2017, Sony will be discontinuing PlayStation Now on the PlayStation 3, the Vita, PlayStation TV, and then some other fucking TVs.
So PlayStation Now is a service that allows you to basically transfer your game onto like your Vita or something from the PS3, right? Or like switch between.
I thought it was like a Netflix kind of deal. Not like Netflix, but like you could like have it like stream whatever to your
device. Exactly. Yeah, you could have stream it to different devices and stuff. Yeah, that's what it is. I'm thinking of multiplayer.
I think that's crossplay, not crossplay, but multiplayer
or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
I never used it because I didn't have a Vita.
I have Vita. Never used it.
Yeah, man, Vita's such a cool.
Vita was device. A cool concept.
Hold on,
it was
wait. Before you continue, this if you want to talk about the Vita, February 15th was the 5th anniversary of the Vita.
Hey,
continue. Cool.
5 years of JRPGs and visual novels.
Yep, pretty much. I have Vita. I bought it on launch day, I believe. I think I have a total of 4 games for it.
Do you regret your purchase?
Yes.
Okay. Aww.
Because it was too much money for too little.
It was $300, I think, at release, right?
But
$300,
$350. Just games did not come to that platform.
Which is a shame, because the hardware was great.
Yeah.
It was the everything else, the software.
The only developers for it were Japanese developers that made JRPGs.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is Sony refused to support it.
Yeah.
That's so messed up.
Like, you'd have E3 conferences without them mentioning Vita at all.
Yep.
I think it's crazy.
I played...
What is, like, internal sabotage?
I played Persona 4 Golden on the Vita, which was a masterpiece of a game.
Yeah.
Great game. I also played the second game in the 999 series.
Yep.
Which was also
18,
phenomenal.
18, 18.
Yes.
Okay.
No, it was Virtue's Last Reward, I think it was called. But
what is it?
Great. Virtue's Last Reward.
Virtue's
Last Reward. As someone dies across the street.
Yeah, really.
But if anyone likes visual novels with a lot of like mind blow, like twists and stuff, that was a great trilogy. But
I know, yeah, you guys recommended that to me, you and your fiance.
999, Virtue's Last Reward, and Zero Time Dilemma.
There's only two or three games.
Those are three. I just named them.
Wait, you named three there?
999, Virtue's Last Reward.
Oh, okay,
and,
okay. I thought you were saying 999 Virtue's Last. Yeah. Damn you, Japan.
No, yeah, no, the names are stupid, but the story is phenomenal.
What's the dumbest name you've heard for a game?
God.
Haven't you asked that?
I think I did, because we talked about Kingdom Hearts. You know,
pretty sure you asked that. That might have been like the first, maybe not the first podcast, but I'm pretty sure you asked that.
Yeah, that means nobody answered.
No, we answered.
What'd you say, Blake?
I think we're talking about fucking.
If you answered, it'd be consistent.
There's some pretty dumb names out there. When you go into like JRPGs that have like 20 words in the name.
I thought that new RPG coming out at Square Enix at the Nintendo Direct looked really dumb. It's like
Octopaths.
Yeah, whatever it was.
Octopaths. Something. I don't fucking remember.
That's a dumb name.
Yeah, that's pretty
dumb.
I'm sure I'll find something. No, he brought his old notes.
Whoa.
Well, I mean, whatever. I mean, I can't think off the top of my head the worst, like, named game.
It's a JRPG with a really long name.
Project Octopath Traveler.
Yeah, that's a bad
name.
Yeah,
what a dumb name. That doesn't convey anything.
Nope.
Man, I think it's just a code name. I don't think it's going to be a fucking real
Maybe.
Title.
I don't know.
Maybe. I don't know.
Well...
We shall see.
We shall see.
We're talking about the Vita.
Oh, yeah, thank you.
Man, the Vita.
I mean, I had a friend who carried around the Vita a lot with him.
Yeah.
And I always liked looking at it and stuff. And it was cool to watch him play older games on it. Like, he played Legend of Dragoon on it. And I was like, oh, it's my favorite game of all time. I'm going to love that and shit. And, and I was like, wait, that's a, like, whatever. Like, that's a game that came out on PS1. Like,
yeah,
where's the good shit?
Where's the new titles for this? Where's the competition for the 3DS?
Mm-hmm. You know, and it's just literally
there was none.
Yeah, it didn't exist.
You can play Final Fantasy 15 on it.
That's true. If you own it on PS4.
Yeah. So that's cool. Whatever. All right. Well, let's all give a moment of silence for the Vita. Done. All right.
All right, next.
Do you think Sony would ever announce like a successor?
No.
No.
I think not that yet. Was their last hurrah.
Yeah.
DS has the market.
Yeah. Them dropping the ball with the Vita gave the 3DS the, like, the market it needed. Yeah. Like, there was no competition. Now there just will never be competition. So there's no point. I think even Microsoft said they were wanted to release a portable console when the Vita came out, and then they never did.
Like, ugh.
Yeah, which was probably a smart move.
That would have been weird.
Yeah.
I just imagine like an X-shaped mobile device and it being awful. Like,
yeah.
It's like a bop it. Like...
It's a bop it. That's
just
all it is.
They just release a bop it.
Yo, I'm down.
With the Xbox logo on it.
I'm down. Microsoft, get on that.
I'd buy it.
Yeah, the Microsoft bop it. All right, what's next?
So Best Buy will give out free Zelda posters if you go to their Switch midnight launch, and I only mention that because I'm going to be there and I want a poster.
Cool.
That's
cool.
Let me ask, is it really a Best Buy? The Best Buy?
What?
Best Buy. You're asking Do you get questions. The Best Buy?
Well, think about this.
I think that's too deep for a two-hour conversation. No,
think about this. If you go to GameStop, right?
Yeah.
If you go to GameStop on the midnight release of Zelda, you're like, yo, give me Zelda. They're like, okay, and they give you Zelda, right? If you go to Best Buy, they give you Zelda plus a poster for the same price.
That's...
What?
While supplies last.
Supplies last.
So it could potentially be the Best Buy.
I agree.
Oh, speaking of GameStop, in reference to our conversation last week about the circle of life and all that stuff, which, out of context, what I just said is really weird. Which is like, you know, the conversation we had last week about the circle of life, you know? But earlier this week, my friend, my roommate, I came home from work, and she was like, I got these, and she got new copies of Ratchet and Clank, the reboot, the new one, and Last Guardian. And like, they were on sale, and they were both new, and I was like, and as soon as I saw that, I said, how did it feel putting someone out of the job?
Did you ask her if they like asked if she wanted to buy them used and everything?
You know, I didn't ask that. I should have.
They probably asked her.
Yeah, most likely.
It's like, but, please buy it used.
Man, it's just
they're watching me.
That's weird that they would put new games on sale like that. I mean, especially the Last Guardian, she got like $20 off, which is really
I think that's a permanent price drop.
Really?
I think it just got
Price
dropped.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like 2 summers ago when I bought WWE 2K15 for the Xbox One, it was $30 new, but like $55 used.
What?
Like, it was on sale. And they're like, you want to buy it used? I'm like, nope.
Please.
I do not.
Please. I have 3 kids. Yeah, I just thought that was kind of funny.
Yeah.
The props so soon after.
I haven't gone to GameStop in so long, and I probably won't go back.
I don't have a reason to go right now, so until they give me a reason, I'm just going to get all my games digital.
Yep.
Or on Amazon.
Same.
You make me sick. The digital part.
Okay.
No, I buy all my games digital.
Fuck you.
Just wait. When the robots turn on us, Blake's Hardware will save the day.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Go on.
So, in Dissidia, Final Fantasy, the new arcade.
The arcade Japanese version.
Sephiroth is getting his Kingdom Hearts closed.
So cool. They did that in, they gave Squall his Kingdom Hearts close, and they also gave Cloud his Kingdom Hearts close in the PSP version.
Like from Kingdom Hearts 1?
Yeah, from 1.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, yeah. Because he already had Advent Children, so. But yeah, it was totally like red, you know. It was like the Vincent sort of looking gear. But that's really cool. Too bad we still haven't
heard any. I could have sworn
play that game
it's
so
eventually coming to PS4. No,
I didn't fact check.
Fact check, bro.
I'm 99.9% sure it's not.
So
I haven't released
when I went
it
to Japan, I went to the arcades. And the arcades there are phenomenal.
Yep.
The games play so awesome. And I know that that game will play equally as awesome. I just want it. I want it here to play. I played a Gundam arcade cabinet there where you have like 2 pistols, like light gun pistols. And you can, like, put them together, like, puzzle piece to make a shotgun.
Wow,
it's
awesome.
So cool.
That is actually cool.
It's awesome. And I know that Dissidia probably plays really well. It looks kind of like the Naruto fighting games, in a way.
They said there's going to be a port, but there's no announcement, which we knew there was going to be a port. But I'm reading an article here. Yep.
What's the website?
You're right.
Gamasu.
Gamasu, thank you. Gamasu.
I know.
Zamasu.
I know what website you're talking about. They're pretty reputable.
Even if they just make a Japanese PS4 port,
yeah, you can just import it.
Yeah.
Worst comes to worst.
Yeah.
Like, I imported J-Stars, Victory Versus. Mm-hmm. Did I say the title right?
I think so.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So I imported it, and I got it for Colby.
Yeah.
When it was on PS3.
Yeah.
And then, like, so it was, like, $80 to import it from, like, PlayAsia or wherever the fuck I got it from. And then, like, a month later, it was, like, coming.
I know. That was,
and I was like, fuck.
I played that a bunch, too, and I missed out on a lot of content because it was all in Japanese.
Yeah.
Story mode, I was like, I can't even, like, I can barely touch
this. That game was, like, decent.
It was fun. I mean, playing as Bobobo in a fighting game, it's probably.
I just wish you could play as Yami.
Yeah, that would have been cool, like, in the DS version.
They never really updated that game, did they?
No.
No, they didn't add any characters or whatever.
That kind of sucks.
They had a good opening roster, though. Like, it was cool playing as, like, Kenshin and stuff like that. But
and Goku.
And Goku. Don't forget Goku.
And Naruto.
And Naruto. Actually, I have a little special something.
Yeah.
I have a gift.
Yes.
To give.
The gift Please of Jericho?
Do. Please to do. Blake.
Me?
It's open. Yeah. Don't mind, it has a couple cracks in it. Rustle the paper so they know you're opening something.
Thank you. What the fuck is this?
I got, because, you know.
Who's Ashley Anderson?
Don't worry about it.
Oh, I ordered that online.
Don't worry. $2 postage? What is this?
Wow, just take the fucking gift.
Oh my god.
What is it?
Digimon World 3.
What?
I know. I'm sorry there's a crack on the case. It was either that or I spend like $80 on like a brand new copy. So, but it, you know, it's guaranteed to work and stuff. Because I threw away the other copy and you got really mad on podcast, so I felt bad. So, literally that night, I ordered a new one for you. That one. So.
Oh my god.
I didn't know about this before we recorded.
And now it's recorded and.
Time to never play it.
Yeah, that's exactly. Yeah, I wasn't about to spend $80 that I gave you, will never touch.
That's awesome.
No problem.
I did not expect. I was kind of like half joking when I was yelling at you.
Yeah. Blake isn't even a Digimon fan. I bet he can't even name like three Digimon.
There's a. Wait. Nice hand on the back.
Don't look on the back.
You can't even say like Agumon.
Stop, don't do ideas.
I was going to say Agumon, but
you had an R there. You were going to say Aruman.
The first one.
Rabumon.
Wait. Oh god! Yeah, but you're saying no Digimon.
Just say something with the word with Mon after it.
Pikachu Mon.
Wait, I'm ready, bro. Wait, no.
Just say Mon.
These are just showing main characters.
Say something with Mon.
Show me a Digimon. God damn it! I'm looking through the.
Look what your physical copies do for you now, Blake.
Wait.
Just say a word.
Wait.
Say a word.
I'm looking through the manual right here. Why wouldn't they tell me any fucking Digimon names?
You don't see, like, Pikachu or whatever on, like, the Pokemon games.
I'm sure there's Pikachu in the fucking
instruction
booklet.
Oh, maybe in the instruction booklet.
Yeah, that's what I'm looking through,
Just say a word.
Maybe not,
just
though.
Just say a word, man. Just say a word.
I give up.
There you go.
I've been smeckled up.
Smeckled up. That's not even a word, and I agree with you. So there you go.
Cool, it's like thanks.
Greymon, War Greymon.
War Greymon.
Now I just need Anthony to Metal buy Greymon. Me a Metal copy Greymon. Of Smackmaster Raw 2009, but he won't.
Angelmon.
And you can rest in peace like the vengeful spirit you are.
thanks.
Yeah, no problem.
Hercules Kabuterimon.
Hercules Kabuterimon. Blake, get with it.
Is that real?
Yeah.
Hercules Kabuterimon. Kabuterimon, Mega Kabuterimon, Hercules Kabuterimon. I think there's Golden Kabuterimon as well.
See, this is why Pokemon's more popular.
What the fuck? Oh, it's only value of Mega Pinsir. I don't know. Whatever.
Shut up.
Actually, to be fair, like, there's a weird point in the Digimon era where, like, all the Digimon kind of look the same after, like, Gen 3.
Yeah.
They're all, like, knights. It's looking. It looks stupid.
Yeah, stupid. Dumb.
Although, I'm sorry, I'm going to go off on a little Digimon rant.
Yeah, go for
Digimon
it.
Digimon Try, which is a new series they've been releasing in portions.
Yeah.
It's not finished yet. Is amazing. It takes the first like, gen, whatever, of Digimon and, like, grows the characters up into, like, late high school.
Yeah.
And, like, throws them in, like, a new situation where, like, they're more mature and shit. And,
yeah.
Oh, it's so good. It has feels. Ty contemplates death and, like, stuff. Like, people die. Like, freaking, even one episode, I'm not going to spoil anything. It's really good. Watch it. Like, if you're a Digimon fan, like, I stopped watching Digimon after, like, the third season.
Me
I was,
too.
Like, too old for it, whatever. This is, like, perfect. It's so, if you want, like, a series to grow up with you, this one did. This is cool.
Man.
And it gets rid of all the bullshit of past Digimon stuff. So
I miss the .hack series.
You know, I never liked that show when I was a kid.
Yeah.
Because it was at a point when I was really young, I didn't like anime.
Yeah.
Because it was too scary for me. Because it was a lot of blood. Because I remember one of the first things I saw in anime was like probably like Full Metal Alchemist, the original series. Mm-hmm. And it was probably the first episode because I remember them, it being horrifying.
Losing their limbs and stuff.
Oh, yeah, and the mother like, yeah. Just like, well, I'm going to go back to watching, like, I don't know.
SpongeBob.
That's So Raven. That was SpongeBob. On late. SpongeBob. Uh-huh. Yeah. And Dot Hack was one of those shows in that era where I was like, I don't want to watch this.
Yeah. Dot Hack came out in a weird time because it came out alongside anime like Cowboy Bebop, Trigun, Kenshin, Gundam, you know, like all those. So like, everyone in like middle school and when we were in like middle school and high school and stuff like was watching those shows, and Dot Hack was like a really slow paced like all dialogue show.
Yeah.
And like, but it captivated me. I loved it.
I mean, it's
show.
Super popular for a reason, you know. Yeah. Those two games were pretty good. It took me forever to I played the GU series.
Yeah.
So I played it with like no prior knowledge of the other three games or four games, right? Remember four?
Three games. No, four games.
Yeah, it was four because then GU was three.
Yeah, there were seven.
I stopped at like the final boss or whatever in the third disc.
Uh-huh.
And then like finally my friends convinced me like a year after to like jump back into it. I beat it and I was like, well, I never want to touch this again.
Yeah.
It was a fun game though. It's a weird like not MMO.
Yeah, it kind of got overshadowed by Sword Art. It kind of doesn't exist anymore because Sword Art exists.
It's the same premise. People get stuck in a video game and
people
die.
Go into comas and get stuck in the video game. You know, it's the same thing. But
you die in the game, you die in real life.
But like the original anime was so cool because like it was like one guy stuck in the game and like all these other people that are in the game with him are like trying to figure out why he's stuck in the game like in real life. But like doesn't show them in real life, it just shows them in the game.
No.
So like they come back and talk and they're like, I investigated this like yesterday, and it's like I kind of like met up with this person.
It's a bummer that premise for a show is kind of shitty now.
Yeah,
because of Sword Art.
Yeah,
it's really oversaturated. Although that show I talked about last week, Konosuba, is that premise, but it's really fucking good.
They have a lot of anime with that premise now.
What was Large Horizon? I watched that and I was a couple episodes in and I was like, this sucks. Yeah. Like I'm done. I am so done with the people get stuck in a fantasy RPG, right?
It's all over the place now.
Yeah, it's sickening. It's kind of like it's the same way that vampires were a fad, but like more with anime.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot of vampires.
There's another one. Isn't there like ReZero is one? It's the same premise.
Kind of. It's not a game though.
Oh.
It's never game based. It's the same basis where one guy gets stuck in another world.
Yeah.
Nah, that show's awesome though.
Yeah.
That show is really, really good. It's like a really good recent anime that. It's in its off season now, so it's not airing any new episodes right now, but that's a good one. ReZero. 10 out of 10.
10 out of 10?
10 out of 10.
If you could be stuck in any video game, what would it be?
Is that
Colby's hypothetical?
Colby. All right, new segment. This is Colby's hypothetical questions. All right, if I could be stuck in any video game, what would it be?
Yeah.
Resident? No. Oh. What about you, Blake?
Any
Animal
game.
Crossing?
Dead or Alive.
Oh my god. Wait.
Beach volleyball.
Okay, I was gonna say the fighting.
not the fighting.
It's like you only have a limited window to say like dead or alive, you're just a teleport and get the shit kicked out of you by like the Ninja Gaiden fucking dude.
No ifs or buts. Well, there's buts. But
you'd be a casino? Like,
yeah.
Man. I'd be a total just like child weeb and just be like Kingdom Hearts, because I was just like when I was a kid. I would love to be a Keyblade Warrior.
You'll probably be on a world that like gets...
No, you get turned into a white guy. You get turned into a Heartless,
Oh, fuck. Like that one guy in Kingdom Hearts in Traverse Town. He's like, no!
The only guy who dies in Kingdom Hearts.
Yep, the only death in Kingdom Hearts. Oh, man, now I'm looking around for like inspiration. Ah, man. What about you, David, while I buy time?
If I get stuck in any game...
The Sims.
Sims. I could just live my life. I want to say like, you know, like a fantastical RPG world, but my life would actually probably suck if that happened.
That's what I'm saying, right?
I'd be a vendor and I couldn't move
for real
ever.
It's like the whole glorified thought of like, yeah, I could be the main character, but it's like
if you're not the main character, you're probably gonna die.
Think of all the times that you're a main character, you're playing a game and you get hit right with like a sword or something. They're just like, oh. But like in reality, be like, fuck my arm, you just flip the fuck out.
Yeah, for real, it's tough. It's tough to think.
Oh man, looking over, Ashura's wrath.
Oh man,
I just throw like two arms and just beat the shit out of things.
That'd be pretty intense.
It would have to be, I guess, I just love RPGs so much.
Yeah, me too.
I want to be like a mage in something, because why would I want to do something normal? Like, oh, I can like shoot a gun really well. Or I mean, yeah, that's pretty cool, but like, I want to throw a fireball.
Titties.
I want to see. Blade wants to go beach volleyball. And do you know the end of those games? A volcano erupts.
I get out in time.
Wait, what?
You didn't know that?
No.
The end of like the first one? Like, you're on New Zack Island or Zack Island or whatever. It's just this dude who's like, hey, I got all these bitches and stuff in here. And
the volcano erupts.
Yeah, and it's on like a, yeah, like a tropical island. The volcano explodes and like drowns the whole place in lava.
I don't even think
it specifies if everybody escapes, but there's a sequel, so everybody did. I mean, I don't know. It's like Pompeii situation.
That's so weird.
I'm gonna cheat and say a Star Wars game.
I'm gonna cheat and say Parappa the Rapper.
There you go.
Kick, punch. Don't have much time.
And everything's happy and everyone's just singing all the time.
That'd be really funny. I wouldn't. Well,
I'd love to say like Pillars of Eternity or something, but then I would just probably die from like a.
I wouldn't choose an old like fantasy game.
Yeah.
I like indoor plumbing. You know.
Yeah.
I was about to say Pokemon.
Mm-hmm. That'd be cool,
but I wouldn't be like a fighter. Like, I wouldn't force my little pet to fucking kill for me.
I
like,
would
faint.
Sorry, I mean, not like you always see like an NPC with just like, this is my Pikachu, I don't battle, but this is my Pikachu.
Exactly. Yeah. Then you see a lot of people in Lavender Town.
I would get an Onix and rob banks with it, because would, who's gonna mess with an Onix? Or Steelix. It's just made of steel.
That's
which region would you want to be in?
Let's go Johto. Why not?
Johto?
But
fuck
no.
Yeah.
Maybe. I kind of like the...
Hoenn?
No. Gen...
Kalos?
Yeah, Kalos.
Okay.
Thank you.
Right,
the whole
regions.
French sort of...
Unova? Yeah, it's
yeah.
Kalos.
Just become a Pokemon master, catch legendaries, and then just like alter time and space with them, because I can do that.
That's true. The world's kind of fucked up.
Yeah.
Honestly, my final answer is probably Kingdom Hearts.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You're going to be that one guy in Traverse Town.
I know.
Yep.
But at least I'll see Sora.
Which world would you want to be in? Because you can't, like, you don't have a fucking gummy ship.
Wait, can I be the main character?
Not fucking Sora. No. Sora's already Sora.
So I have to be, like, a nameless NPC, right? Or maybe I forge my own.
Yeah, forge your
do
own.
Do I at least get a Keyblade? Maybe.
I don't know.
Maybe I'm not strong of heart.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Maybe if I was in any world, Twilight Town. Because it feels like the most complete world. It has a beach. You know, it wasn't in the game, but just that's because Diz didn't
program
it.
Has a dope-ass Disney train.
Yeah.
It was a dope-ass Disney train. And also,
ice
I like
cream.
The music.
Yeah.
But are we going to talk about...
Talk about what?
They stole the word.
Oh, fuck.
What?
That's right. They stole our...
Oh. Damn it.
Man, I can't find them. They used to be right there. That was such a weird part of that game.
Yeah. It really was.
I was so confused.
So,
where
do I
go?
Yeah,
we're not going to explain that joke, by the way.
Nope.
If you played Kingdom Hearts 2, you know.
Yep.
But, man, I was actually thinking about this. I was just driving, whatever, and it dawned on me that... Radiant dawned on me? That Roxas is like probably like one of the most developed characters in that
series.
Roxas!
Yes, he probably is, yeah.
Roxas. He's so... And everybody gives him shit, right? Because he has a, you know, that shitty
he's
part of the
Sora.
Game. Yeah. I mean, to be fair, the beginning of that game was, like, way too long to spend as Roxas, kind of doing useless shit. But, like, people are just like, man, Roxas fucking sucks. He's just, whatever, fuck him.
Yeah.
And, boy.
He fucking sucks. fuck him.
Roxas sucks.
Roxas? Well, it sucks us. I don't know. But he, like, think of that one point in Kingdom Hearts 2. Where he sees Diz's computer and he flips out and destroys it.
Yeah.
Like,
you gotta realize.
Kind of like Kylo Ren.
Oh my god. That's it. Kylo Ren.
Kylo Ren.
Oh my god.
It's. He finds out in the course of the beginning of that game that he wasn't meant to exist. How fucked up. How do you expect someone to take that? And like, nobody ever really like has any in depth discussions about him as a character of all the shit he goes through. If you read like even like the mangas for 358 over 2, even in the game itself, and really like, watched Shion, one of his only like two friends die and then forced to forget her
or never exist.
It's Yeah, learning no never
really,
exists.
Yeah, no one really, like, addresses that, yeah, like, emotional trauma.
Yeah, plus, at the end, he's just like, time to get back to the other Sora. Like, he doesn't fight it at all.
Well, I think,
and Sora's just like, no kind of exist.
Yeah.
That's what I'd say. Sora's
being there's no discussion of it, because he's a nobody.
Oh, fuck. Spoiler. <nah. laughs> Spoilers for Dave 07, or whatever, or 05.
06.
06. Sonic 06. I don't know. Roxas was like, man, I mean, it just went away from the hypothetical question.
That's fine.
But Twilight, I choose Twilight Town, the final answer, because it's the most complete town there. It's Traverse Town is always dark and dank and whatever. Yeah. So,
would you want to live in the world that never was? In those one of those like skyscrapers, man, being like a fucking office assistant.
Do people live there? Yeah, well, there's a legit skyscraper, so they're like citizens of that town.
Probably like dust. I'd assume. Everywhere. You know the dusts, the base heartless or nobodies.
Nobody.
In the 358 over 2, they're really funny because, and I think in Kingdom Hearts 2 when they're funny too, because they're like the lackeys of organizations. So they're like the butlers.
Yeah.
So like when they tell them to do something, they're kind of goofy because like they're kind of incompetent.
Uh-huh.
So it's actually really fun. They'll like fumble around and stuff. It's just a way different light than, you know, in the game.
Huh.
But
I agree.
Well, did you answer? You didn't give a final answer.
I didn't give a final answer. I think I would live in New Donk City.
New Donk City? That's a good...
Fuck, you're right.
So just normal-ass people?
Yeah.
All
right. But with Mario walking around. With
Mario walking around. Yeah. All
right.
You just see an Italian plumber on the scaffold.
New Donk City.
So that's a preview of our new segment on this show called Colby's Hypothetical Questions.
Just go off the rails for a minute.
Yep. Where just randomly in the middle of the show, one of us is just going to ask a random hypothetical question that could pertain to... Not even video games, to pertain to anything.
Yeah.
If you guys have ideas for Colby's hypothetical questions.
Just ass.
Yeah, huh?
Just ass.
Yeah, just ass.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just ass.
No specifics.
Are we still stuck on Zach Isle? Never mind.
Nah, bro. Get your mind out of the gutter, all
right? Whatever, you're living there.
Damn straight. <You're>
Fuck.
Move on, moving on.
Yeah. That's a news.
So news. So everyone see that the title screen, the menu, like the
Switch
select
menu
screen for Kingdom Hearts 1.5 plus 2.5.
Oh no, I didn't. Looks beautiful. I thought you were talking about Switch.
Looks beautiful.
Probably does.
Has all six.
It does look really nice.
Selectable.
I think the only blemish on it is
what
it's like a few games down. Mm-hmm. You see Kingdom Hearts recoded.
Ah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I should realize that. I think it's an error. Yeah.
Just erase it.
Yeah. Right. They did literally put like a middle finger there, and I'd probably be an improvement.
Yeah.
It's coming out next month.
Dude, I know. That's cool. My friend
just came out.
Yeah, seriously.
Man,
my friend got 2.8, never played Kingdom Hearts before, and he was talking about it in chat. And he's like, oh, I think you played Kingdom Hearts 1 or whatever. He's like, man, can't wait to bust this out. And I'm like, are you serious? He's like, yeah, but I think I'm going to wait for the 1.5, 2.5, and I'm like, yeah, what the fuck? Like, what?
Who's Aqua?
Yeah, like, what are you doing? You wouldn't know anything, but good on you, pal.
Yeah.
Getting into the Kingdom Hearts series. Now you have an easy way to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Sponsor us, Square Enix. We've literally talked about this for 7 episodes, how good Kingdom Hearts is.
Our last.
Oop. Yep.
We'll turn on the light here.
Keep turning on the light.
No. All right. So the last news story, and probably no. Oh,
you're mixing up your notes, Moran.
There's two more news stories. All right. So I guess some dude got his Nintendo Switch.
Some dude, yeah, got it.
Some dude on NeoGaf.
That sentence could have went anywhere. Like some dude, like
it always seems like there's some dude on NeoGaf. Yeah. That's always how every leak starts.
Yeah. So some he got we don't know store mailed it early, but he got a Switch.
Real quick,
what
people don't know, what is NeoGaf?
It's an internet forum
mm-hmm.
that is sometimes and mostly toxic.
Very good.
That is what it is. A lot of insiders, quote unquote, post leaks on it to games like unreleased information, release dates, stuff like this, like the Switch UI or whatever. The mods do filter.
Mm-hmm.
If there's like an obvious fake leak, they'll filter it out and be like, that's fake, get out of here, or whatever, something like that. But if it looks real, potentially real, they'll let the post go. And that's
been around for a while.
Been around for a long time.
And they do like they sometimes do a deal like if it's like specific information, it's gonna be like revealed on this day. And it's like if it's that day and it's not revealed, we're gonna ban you.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's like a lot of accountability.
Mm-hmm.
But usually it's very toxic.
Yeah.
Like
so good. Just for the people.
Gamergate, etc.
Oh yeah, fair enough.
Anyways, don't want to get into that. Yeah. But so someone got their Switch early and they don't have any games for it. So like. This guy posted videos of like the Switch UI and it's very clean, very quick, and
Nintendo's been always good with their system UIs.
Yeah,
although
the Wii U's kind of slow.
I was gonna say switching between the Wii U.
Did you just say switching
between the Wii U and the Wii UIs? You know how like for the virtual sort of
If you want to play a Wii game, you have to go into like the Wii.
That's annoying.
Menu. Because like there's a Wii built into the Wii U. It's so dumb. It's weird.
It's so dumb.
Yeah.
But that's cool. I'm glad the NX.
Yeah. Their UIs have always been clean. Like the 3DS UI is clean. Wii UI is clean. This one looks clean.
Like
I haven't seen it yet.
There was two like color like base colors you can pick like as your like main color. You could pick basic white or basic black.
Basic bitch.
They're keeping it sleek.
Yeah.
Nice. What if I want basic magenta?
That's
DLC.
Magenta DLC. Isn't basic, Colby.
It's refined.
Yeah.
It's my birthstone.
Learn your colors. Come on.
Shame.
Go on.
But yeah, it looks cool. I hope Nintendo, I think they're going to have like a Nintendo Direct before the Switch comes out.
Probably.
Because they did that for the Wii U where it was like, it comes out in a week, here's a bunch of information about it, you should probably know. Like stuff about Virtual Console and like the eShop.
They'll probably do that.
Yeah. So yeah, that's cool. So the big news story of the week, in my opinion,
is
Breath of the Wild. It's getting DLC.
Getting DLC.
What do you mean, of course? No. I mean, of course.
I think it's funny.
What does it compare to this week, huh? Splatoon 2 Global Test Fire? Fuck it.
I don't know.
Dragon Ball Fusions DLC? Nah. Fucking 5th anniversary of the Vita? Fuck it. All right? This is the big news story of the week.
He's right. All right? He's right.
Let me ask you a question.
All right.
What kind of DLC? Is it paid or free DLC?
Good that you asked.
Yeah.
So... All right, so they announced this the other day. It's $20.
$20. So it's paid DLC.
It's for both the Switch and the Wii U version.
Okay, cool.
There's two DLC packs.
Yep.
Cannot be purchased individually. It's all or nothing.
Is it two?
Oh wait, so there's two.
Is it two or three?
Two.
Sorry. It's two packs, but one purchase.
Yeah.
So it's one pack.
Yeah. Very strange.
It's like it'll make sense in a sec. All right. So There's technically three DLC things.
Yeah.
So when you buy it, there's an expansion pass bonus, which you get the day of, like March 3rd.
Expansion pass bonus.
Yeah. So there's three treasure chests that appear in the Great Plateau, which is the starting area.
Yeah.
It contains, I'm using air quotes here, useful items. So I assume it's like, ooh, a bomb.
I thought it'd be something like more significant, like... Experience boost accessory.
Is there experience?
Yeah, there is. You level up.
Really? Oh, do you?
Yeah.
I didn't even know. I just used that as an example.
I'm pretty sure you level
up. Like, level up your cooking faster or something. I don't know.
Is there?
Maybe like sure a special is, yeah. cooking pot.
I'm not sure there is.
I thought there was.
No, I don't think there's a... Because there isn't like a number-based system for attacking. Really? There's RPG elements like
crafting. I thought I heard there was a leveling system.
I don't think you
system.
Can level up.
It's probably going to be like something like... Do your...
Because if you use your amiibo... like the special ones that work with the game, you can here's arrows or whatever, but so I don't think it'll be anything like it says useful, but I don't think it'll be like, oh, you can only get it with this.
Here's a hook shot.
It could be something. So it could be like a new item that you don't need to complete the game, but it's just like
cool. That's what I'm thinking.
I don't think they'd want to put that
or probably like a potion of some kind, right? I could definitely see them like a potion that gives you like double hearts for temporarily. Yeah. Something that boosts you up really powerful.
Yeah, we'll see. What else is there?
So you can just go fight Ganon.
There's two of the chests have like useful items, but the third chest has an exclusive in-game clothing. So it's a shirt you can wear, and it has the Nintendo Switch logo.
That's stupid. That's pretty dumb, yeah.
I thought it was going to be like a jock strap.
Take that immersion.
Yeah. I was about to be like, oh, cool, aesthetic changes, and it's like a Switch t-shirt. I was like, oh, I don't even want that IRL.
I don't think you need product placement in your own game, Nintendo.
Yeah. I think it's just like, you know how like the Mario Kart DLC, you could drive a Mercedes.
Yep.
As fucking
That's
Mario.
Funny. I really like that. That's
so it's
hilarious.
Just being hokey.
Yeah.
I wish it was like you could wear a Mercedes branded shirt. I'd be down with that. Continue the partnership.
Yeah, I'll just keep
like
doing it.
Like the Mercedes returns in a fucking Mario Maker.
They should have put like, it'd be funny if you had like a Mario hat.
That'd be stupid.
Wow. All right. Go ahead and walk around your Mercedes shirt.
Is that all the $20 gets you?
Well, so that's like what you get off the bat. And obviously, I don't think it'll be like super useful items.
Yeah.
But, so. DLC Pack 1, which comes out in the summer of 2017.
Wait, so when you buy the pass,
yep.
you get those items and you get all of this you're about to list?
Yeah.
And the pass is 20, so it's a season pass.
Yeah. It says expansion pass.
Yeah, but you can't get them individually.
It's strange.
But, you get them in waves.
Yeah.
So DLC Pack 1 comes out sometime in the summer.
Okay.
It does three things. Mm-hmm. One, and this is all vague jargon.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
like... All right, so
I'm probably going to be pretty critical about it, but
yeah. So it adds a new Cave of Trials challenge. So in Wind Waker, there was the pit of a no, that's fucking Thousand Year Door. So there was like 100 floors, and you could fight enemies. And in Twilight Princess, in the HD version on the Wii U, you could scan the Wolf Link amiibo, and it's like a Cave of Trials.
Yeah,
it's not.
Well, it's not a dungeon. It's like it's a gauntlet, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So it's like a battle tower type thing. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And in Twilight Princess HD, it was like just like a menu option. Like you like it just warps you to some location that's not like put in the world.
Yeah.
So I hope that's like
it's more integrated this
way. It's not like here's a menu.
Yeah.
you know, it's like more integrated in the world.
Alright, so that's cool.
Second thing is a new hard mode. And it says new hard mode, so people are like, oh, they're putting hard mode behind a paywall. So I think it means like, so in Wind Waker HD, Skyward Sword, and Twilight Princess HD had this too. There was hero mode.
Yep.
So that would get rid of hearts and all enemies do double damage.
That was even in Ocarina of Time. It was a type of hero mode. It would reverse all the dungeons.
Yeah, and like
that's
just,
the master quest.
Yeah, it's same. It's yeah, yeah, similar to that. Yeah.
So people are like, oh, they're hiding hero mode behind that, but like the way it's phrased,
the new hard mode,
it kind of makes it seem like maybe it's gonna be like Master Quest, or like everything's gonna be mirrored and all the dungeons different. Yeah. We don't know. Yeah. That's the thing.
Or just like hard mode plus, or even harder. You know.
The thing is, a lot of the stuff they're too vague, and we don't
know.
And people are like outraged about vague statements.
If it's simply, I'll say this: if it's simply like you said, drain hearts, they do double damage. That's not worth paying for.
You do not charge for that.
That'd be dumb.
But the way they phrase it makes it imply that it's an additional hard.
If it shifts everything around, I don't even think like mirroring dungeons is really worth paying for either. Like a mirror mode, that's been in plenty of games.
Yeah,
shouldn't pay for that. But if they add new stuff because of a hard mode, that's totally
A lot of this is like wait and see because we don't know what the fuck they're talking about.
Yeah.
So the third thing in DLC Pack 1 is an additional map feature. What map feature is, we don't know.
An additional map feature.
Yeah, what is that?
Now you can minimize the map.
A lot of this is vague jargon, people are outraged. Like, this should have been in the main games. Like, you don't know what it is.
Yeah. I don't even know what that means.
Yeah.
I don't know either.
Do they add something to the map? Is there no map to begin with? Are they adding a map? Like, what?
We will find out in the summer of 2017.
Find out next week when we don't know.
So that's DLC Pack 1.
Yep.
We don't know what the fuck any of this shit is.
Good call.
Yeah. Cool.
So,
great.
DLC Pack 2.
Yep.
Comes in the holiday of 2017.
Okay.
So, there's a new original story, whatever that means.
Huh.
Probably what I'm assuming is that you'll play as Zelda.
Or a different character.
Or Groose.
Or Groose. Groose will come through Skyward Sword
with
his fucking hair.
Yep.
And be like...
And be voiced by Christopher Sabat. It was Toolbar voice.
I would hope. That's so it. There's a new original story.
Cool.
There's a new dungeon.
Cool.
But like, what constitutes as a dungeon?
Yeah. Yeah. You know?
Don't know. You're just usually locked in a cell. Like yeah. This dungeon.
As Zelda. Additional challenges.
So okay. Probably like achievements.
Whatever yeah. The fuck that means.
Yeah.
So but that's DLC.
That sounds like legit DLC.
Yeah, that's yeah, I agree.
So $20 for that about stuff. I mean, none of this is really explained.
The wave two or the second DLC, the last one you just read, sounds like the most worth it to me.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And so a lot of people are mad because I think the timing of this announcement is weird.
Yeah.
Well, it's so off. Like, why would you announce this DLC, one, before the game showed up, and two, it's not even around until summer.
Yeah.
What hype are you building by giving vague details? I think they probably
should announce this at
E3. Yeah.
Yeah.
But, a lot of games are doing this. Like, that's true. When did they announce Resident Evil's DLC?
Like, before the game came out, I'm pretty sure.
And when's the DLC come out?
The what? Resident Evil 7 DLC?
Yeah, so far.
Like, the last one just came out last week.
What was the first one?
Came out like...
They're coming out regularly.
A couple weeks after the game's release, then it came
out. So that makes it seem like it was just like, all right, we'll just make this content.
Yeah.
Just make it DLC.
Yeah.
I mean, well, this kind of makes it seem like...
Well, to be fair, a lot of games in the department, it's more of like, we have a whole office of people, right, who have finished their job, have finished their specific job. We're just waiting on this specific department to finish their job. In the meantime, let's make DLC, right? Because that's not going to be technically finished and all proper until after the game comes out. Because there's a lot of marketing stuff you have to do for that, too, you know what I mean? So that's might be a reason why, you know, because I know what you're, you know, saying here. Where it feels like they haven't even started, maybe, or you know, maybe they have started on this, but only conceptualized.
I mean, I would hope the game's gold by now, right? The game comes out in fucking 2 weeks.
You never know. Could you imagine if they were just like, so, Switch coming out? A-okay, guys, we're good. Zelda post one. And you know what? The Joy-Con? Yo, awesome.
HD Rumble.
Yeah.
1-2 Switch.
Come on, what's
Arms. Ribbon Girl.
Ribbon Arms. Girl's out.
Or whatever the hell her name is, I don't know.
It's Ribbon Girl.
Is it Spring?
It's Spring Man.
Boy.
Sounds like a bad ripoff of Mega Man. It's a Mega Man villain. Spring Man.
That
console.
I mean, I'm going to buy it. Because
we know.
I know.
We know, Blade.
Although, I think this should be included in the fucking $130 Master Edition I'm fucking paying for.
Oh, wait, it's not included in that? That's
right. This was announced after it.
That's bullshit.
Yeah, it really should be
included. Maybe it'll be like, well, you bought this, here's fucking redeemable. Probably not.
No way.
They should, but they're not going to,
They would have announced that with it, I'd imagine. That's kind of stupid. You pay $130 for the game and you're not even getting the DLC for it.
Yeah,
that's right. But you have a statue.
I mean, a lot of, like a collector's edition of so-and-so, whatever. Like, whatever game. A lot of them do that, too.
Yeah, but a lot also don't do that.
Yeah. It's like, some do, some don't.
It's true.
In a world where I can buy every Kingdom Hearts game to date in one disc, including recoded.
After I've already bought them, like, 3 times.
Yeah. I think it's okay now. Oh, man. Imagine Kingdom Hearts 3 DLC.
Man. It's probably going to be a thing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Well, of course.
But they could do that easy. They could just be like, this Disney movie's added.
Well, that'd be cool. Yeah, that would be actually be pretty cool.
It wouldn't be too hard for them to do.
Anyway.
Like, a lot of people are like, oh, Zelda shouldn't have DLC. Why not?
Yeah, well, why not? Yeah. Every game
can Uncharted have DLC. Has DLC. I'm thinking, like, a lot of single-player games.
A lot of people are against DLC. They think of it, and it's just, like, totally, like, well, cash cow, right?
It can
like,
suck.
I mean, yeah, it can. But
it can also really elongate the game.
Yeah, yeah, I'm supportive of DLC no matter what. I think more of the game I love,
As long as the base DLC is kind of shitty.
As long as it's... as long as it's only cosmetic.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. If it's like, play a new story on day one, it's like, it should be in the fucking game.
Yeah, that's messed up. Yeah, that's underhanded, and a lot of companies don't do that anymore. Only
like the Final Fantasy 15 DLC should have been the main game.
The
Gladio story, the pro, like
they had 10 years to make. They could have spent another year or whatever to
probably should have just slipped it in there.
Yeah, but like you said, it keeps people playing.
Yeah, it does.
So
and I played The Witcher 3 DLC and loved it.
Yeah,
so
DLC is always good as long as the base game is worthy of respect.
Yeah,
and Nintendo's like they just started DLC like with the Wii U and I think they've done a really good job with the Smash DLC, the Mario Kart DLC,
which
had a which had like a season pass.
Yep.
Ouch.
Like, still like, I think also maybe the I don't think the Smash did it.
Smash didn't have a season pass.
Okay.
No.
I know it had like packs.
Well, yeah, but... you could buy the packs, but it did not. I know for a fact it didn't have a season pass. The, you know, it's really interesting to see like post-game content for companies. I think one of the, like a company that did post-game content probably in the most significant and like greatest way was Square Enix with Final Fantasy 14, A Realm Reborn, where they literally, that game sucked so hard on release. They made an in-lore reason where everyone died, the apocalypse happened.
And they entirely remade the game.
Yep, and they just remade the game. That's what we have Final Fantasy 14 now, A Realm Reborn.
Like, the game sucked so bad.
Yeah, isn't that crazy?
It was awful. It was a horrible game. Mm-hmm. And then they were like, a meteor crashed to Earth. Everyone dies, your characters are gone, remade the game.
Like, there was a war going on. Everyone's like, the Bahamut comes down and just massacres everyone. And they're just like... new game. That's a way better game because of it. So that's a really, you know, that's like DLC. It's like a reason for a developer not to give up on a game. It's a way you can make a game better that way.
Yep.
You know, with constant updates post launch. Mm-hmm. You know, paid or unpaid. You know.
Yeah. This is slightly off topic, but slightly not. Have you ever looked into like dead MMOs? Is there some really interesting things?
I've never played a dead MMO.
Like, if there are some MMOs that like where the servers are still up and there's maybe like 20 people playing the game.
Would Club Penguin count?
Well, it's gone.
That's dying. Well, that's not dying. Gone yet. It's dying.
March.
No, that's probably booming right now.
Yeah, probably. Just
like candlelight vigils for
everyone's playing it.
But no, why? What sparked that?
Because I saw a video on Reddit about it's a video on YouTube about a guy who loads up this old MMO from like 2002 or something. And goes on it and starts playing it, and there's like one guy that he finds, like one of the only guys playing the game.
Is this a creepypasta?
No, it's not a creepypasta. He just does it. He just finds the guy playing the game, and the guy starts being all like he starts talking all cryptic to him to like try and freak him out.
Oh yeah,
because like ghost story stuff, and like at the end the guy's just like, hi, like just I'm just messing with you or whatever. But it's really like a cool phenomenon to see like a game that's still running, but like no one's on it. It's just like a dead
MMO. I imagine WildStar is like that now. That's probably a dead MMO now.
Yeah, probably.
Who has talked about WildStar? Let's be real.
Yeah, no one's talked about the game in a while.
Do any of you remember the Kids Next Door MMO?
I didn't even know that was a thing.
I remember I didn't have a computer that could run it.
I didn't know
it
was a game.
Oh, shit. I can't remember the title. Basically, you create
your own guy. Operative.
Uh-huh.
Your operative. And like you play through like different different missions and stuff. Do you remember the Kids Next Door episode where there was like alternate versions of like
when they went in the pool?
Yeah, the pool.
So
that was like versions. That was like a big like
expansion.
No, like a big part of like the reason the game existed.
Okay. Yep.
And like it tied in with it. And it was like a level where like you go in the pool and then you face like your Nega version.
Oh,
what? I had no idea.
I remember wanting to play that so bad as a kid.
It was awesome.
I wasn't able to.
I try to like find like a download of it, and like there's like this like Yahoo Answers from like 2009. It's like, yeah, I have it. I'll send you it. And like I send that guy a message, never responded. But there's, obviously, like fucking 5 years later,
gotta be out there. If Toontown is still up with private servers, we gotta find Kids Next Door somewhere.
Was it like a web-based, like a browser?
Yeah, it was a browser.
No, what? You downloaded it.
Uh-huh. Oh, you're right. Yeah, you're right.
Really?
Mm-hmm. It was a... Cartoon Network used to make some awesome games back in the day.
Yeah, they
back
did.
In elementary school.
They did.
One of my favorites is we used to play it in computer class was the Hector Concarnate, whatever, Billy and Mandy, the base battle where you're the island bases and you have to like purchase your weapons before. Oh man.
So
it was so good.
It was called Operation Best. So it's create your own operative, tackle 7 huge game missions that continue the KND's TV adventure. That was the promotional.
Oh my
god. Right, Let me see.
It looks like a clay model of like ass. I don't know.
Oh god. That does not look good.
And there's only like fucking like 4 screenshots that like exist on the internet, and it makes me sad that like this shit was never archived or whatever. But like all the missions were like,
I had no idea that was a game.
Yeah, like mission 7, number four asks you to jump into a swimming pool where you stumble upon the negative universe. Scout out the area and be sure to put an end to negative number 4's reign.
We We should make a creepypasta about this game.
Yes, we should.
If you actually jump in the pool, you get sucked into the game.
Forever.
In bed drowns. All right, what's that?
But yeah, that was good.
You're talking about DLC.
That was a good game.
Final comments on the DLC, because that was our last news story.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
Good stuff. Cool.
It's cool. I mean,
I think people we need more info. Are mad.
I'm going to reserve. Yeah. Ask me again, Blake, when we get more info.
They could have easily sold all of these separately for $20.
I think they could have like waited and then be like, if you buy it now, you get the three treasure chests. But this could have been June or something.
A pre-order bonus.
No, just for buying the pass.
Oh, the pass. So the game. Sorry.
Yeah, it's a lot of content for $20, I think.
And like a lot of season passes are fucking $35.
I usually
$40. Four Honors is $40.
I usually hate season passes, but they're being very open with what you'll get with the season pass, which is good. Because a lot of games are just like, comes with a season pass, let's hope they make good DLC.
Final Fantasy season pass, like, we'll make something.
No, there's a lot 15? Of stuff for the 15.
No, like originally announced.
Oh, original? Oh, they did.
I think.
I'm pretty sure
they basically said there's a season pass soon after. You're right, though. Initially, it was like, what the fuck? But then soon after, they were like, they were still vague about it. They were like, this character got his own story, this one and that one. And then a co-op. And you're like, cool. It's gotten to a point now where if you got the season pass, you're making out pretty well.
Yeah.
With
I got the season pass. I got the extra items from the first like item delivery thing. And I got the Chocobo Carnival as soon as it came
plus
out.
Plus all the stuff that's going to come out later. Yeah. Which is, did you know they delayed the Power Rangers power suits they have? They were going to release where they because of that comment. People said it looked too much like the new Power Rangers coming out and stuff. And Story Rangers was like, back up.
Yeah.
So that's the magic type armor. That's what I heard.
They're just going to change the look of it a bit, I guess.
So
that's our news.
That's it.
Yeah. But now we go into upcoming releases. Okay. What releases in the next week?
Go.
Right?
Yeah, let's go.
Bring them on.
So we got Berserk and the Band of the Hawk for PC, PlayStation 4, PlayStation Vita.
Is that a game off the anime Berserk?
No, I don't. Oh, actually, it might be. Hold on.
That might be the Berserk like Dynasty Warrior style game.
What is it coming out for?
PC.
Okay.
PlayStation 4, and PlayStation Vita.
Berserk.
All right, Kobe's fact checking this. All right, you got to type a little faster.
My keyboard thing is in the way. Berserk.
Berserk and the Band of the Hawk.
Yeah, that is a Berserk game.
Oh, okay.
So that's the one that's been like coming out for a while.
Is that the Warriors one?
Yes. Yeah, I believe so.
Okay.
I heard that the copies that have been sent out so far weren't that great.
I didn't expect anything from it.
Yeah.
I know people are really big into Berserk. I've never gotten into Berserk before.
Yeah, me either.
So I'm not interested in
it. I'm indifferent about it. It's a Warriors game.
I don't know what Berserk is.
It's an anime where a lot of limbs get chopped off.
Nice.
Yeah, it's like a gory like action anime.
Yeah.
Pretty cool.
Okay, we also got Wise Origin. Am I pronouncing that right? Is it just Wise?
I think it's Ease, actually.
That would probably make more sense.
What? Yeah. It's literally just the letter Y-S.
Yeah.
But,
it's not like W-H-Y-Y.
Yeah, that's how
it's... It's a JRPG franchise.
Is it Wise? No, it's Ease. Like, what?
But
okay.
I've only ever played the first one. It's kind of like, it's like a JRPG, but you have you and your allies like walk alongside with you, and you kind of like tell them to do something.
What's it released for?
PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita. Oh, okay. Vita getting some love this week.
Mm.
It's a JRPG.
That's the fifth birthday present.
Yeah. We also got Halo Wars 2 for PC and Xbox One.
Man. If any of you watch Total Biscuit, go watch his 20-minute rant on how the UI for that game, the key binding menu,
is awful.
like the worst in any game ever.
Yeah. Why does Halo Wars exist? I remember the first one came out and everyone hated it, and now a second one's coming out. What?
I'm super interested in an RTS in that world.
Honestly. Not on console.
Not on console. No RTS should ever come out on a console.
Well, you can play it on Windows.
Whoa!
I assume you can't play it on Steam.
No, Windows Store is the worst thing in existence, and that's probably what you play it on. So
yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And the fourth game releasing this week would be Lego Worlds for the PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, but it got pushed back to March 7th.
What is this world coming to?
Do you know what Lego Worlds is?
It's a Lego game.
It's like Minecraft, I think.
Wow.
No.
Legos?
I think.
I guess that makes sense.
Lego is just copying Minecraft.
I knew it.
Fuck. When's
get
the,
some original ideas with Lego.
When's the Mega Bloks game coming out?
I mean, they have Minecraft Legos. They also have Lego Minecraft now, so I guess it's all the same.
Minecraft is in everything. All right.
And that's it for our new and upcoming releases.
So, any closing comments, gentlemen, before we leave? Been pretty good about this 2 hour.
Where are we at?
1:59
No, okay.
2 hours is just pretty much how long we want to talk to each other without hating each other.
Yeah, so. Exactly.
I already hate you guys.
I already have a knife up the bush right now. But thank you guys so much for joining us on episode 7, February 17th, 2017. Sorry, beginning and end.
Next week may or may not be a normal episode.
Let me say this now. So Blake and I are awful. We have a concert. We're going to see Panic at the Distro live.
Damn straight.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Losers.
So, that's on Monday. Hopefully we can get together beforehand and record the episode and get that done. And then we'll be all set there. Hopefully things will work out conveniently. If not, we'll try and fit something in for that Friday, whether it be some sort of a let's play or something.
Or a themed episode or something.
Yeah, or a themed episode of some kind.
We'll be around either way.
Yeah, definitely. So, and we got more ideas coming to update the show with and everything.
Like, comment, some guests subscribe. In mind.
Yeah, like, comment, favorite, subscribe. You can find
our
us.
Patreon. We don't have a Patreon.
You can find us on SoundCloud.
You can buy our shirts on Teespring.
Blake, I swear to fucking God. ask us questions on Formspring.
What?
Formspring, do you remember that?
I remember that.
Seriously, though, you can find us
ask.
On...
Ask.fm.
Find us on Club Penguin.
You can find me at Club Penguin. Robertum, friend me, and we can sled race and throw snowballs at each other.
I'm so glad I can just mute you. You can find us on Facebook, SoundCloud, Twitter.com/KeepTappinX.
Yeah, it's updated all the time.
Yeah. Thank you, Blake. You can also find us on iTunes Store and Google Play Music. So you can search for us on there for free downloads of the podcast.
Watch for our streams on Twitch.
Yep. We started streaming on Twitch, so you can find that sporadically. Yep. And yeah, that sounds about everything. So, yeah, give our YouTube channel like, comment, favorite, subscribe, all that stuff.
Yeah, all that good stuff.
Yeah, so thank you guys so much for joining us this week. Keep it easy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bye.